watching Notre Dame Football on NBC, presented by Bose.
Home, the place you make and store memories. For nearly 9 decades, these brick walls have been home to legends.
Don't forget, man, today we're gonna win.
Trophy winners.
Touchdown again, Timmy Brown.
And championship teams.
Notre Dame have won the national championship.
But even the most glorious of old houses can be enhanced over time. Today, the gates open on the centerpiece of a campus-changing makeover, where now 21st-century comforts give new life to one of college football's grandest stages. But after a disappointing season, this makeover goes beyond those bricks and video boards. Brian Kelly has a retooled staff, a new starting quarterback, and is emphasizing old-time football principles.
If somebody doesn't execute the technique, we all lose. That's an attention to detail.
You're the face of the future, the blood in my veins, oh, ooh.
Here come the Irish. Season 129 begins in South Bend. Can new beginnings spark a return to familiar glory? Welcome back to Notre Dame football. Welcome home.
And what a day for Notre Dame fans to be welcomed back on campus, the 2017 season opener in the home of Irish football. Notre Dame Stadium sparkling after 3 years of construction has yielded the perfect blend of tradition and state-of-the-art. Brian Kelly's team, off a disappointing 4-8 season, enters 2017 with major changes, including a new leading man, as junior quarterback Brandon Wimbush takes over a potentially potent Irish offense. Test one is Temple, 10-win team each of the last two seasons. They have a new head coach. Jeff Collins makes his debut with the defending American Athletic Conference champs. Welcome to Notre Dame Saturday, everyone. I'm Mike Tirico. If you're the second winningest program in the history of the sport, there's always big anticipation and expectations around Notre Dame football. And this needs to turn around because last year was the worst of Brian Kelly's 7 seasons in South Bend. 3 new coordinators hired, a new strength coach. There's an energy and an attitude change. There's a loaded team on offense, but questions at quarterback and defense. The first test, as mentioned, is Temple. This is a good team. Matt Rhule, now the Baylor coach, turned this team around. Back-to-back 10-win seasons, played for the conference title the last 2 years. They're Philly tough, and they're not intimidated. As one of their players told us last night, this is a big game because we're here. It's a big game because Doug Flutie's here, too. The Heisman Trophy winner and Catherine Tappan will join us before kickoff momentarily. But first, down to the field, Liam McHugh and Chris Sims join us for the U.S. Bank NBC Sports Report. Liam.
Mike, thanks so much. Chris, the newest member of our team, it's good to have you here. First trip back to South Bend since 1998, you were on your recruiting trip. If you want to know how long ago that was in football years, Bob Davey was the head coach and the guy walking you around campus, an assistant coach, some guy named Urban Meyer.
Kind of a big deal, certainly. My first time here on a game day, this is a special place. I've been a part of some big atmospheres in my life. I'm really excited to be here today.
Chris is fired up. Brian Kelly is very fired up for this season. Mike talked about the revamped coaching staff, the new quarterback. He says things have to be drastically different this season. So, fundamentally, philosophically, what's the one change they need to embrace if they're going to be successful?
They need to run the football. It makes a lot of sense. They have one of the best offensive lines in college football, especially on the left side with Nelson and McGlinchey. They have an NFL-type running back in Josh Adams. And, oh, yeah, Brandon Wimbush is making his first college start today. So, take a little pressure off of him with the run game. That'll help set up bootlegs. It'll help set up play action. That's the way to go for me with Notre Dame.
Adams eyeing his first 1,000-yard rushing season here at Notre Dame. As for Temple, you heard it from Mike. They're confident. Maybe they're cocky at this point. And why not? Back-to-back 10-win seasons for the Owls. They think they're going to come into the stadium and walk out with a victory. What do they have to do to get it?
Well, they should be confident. They got a lot of good football players on the team. Jeff Collins is one of the best defensive minds in all of college football. If I'm them, hey, I'm going to put the pressure on Brandon Wimbush. I'm going to put extra people in the box, stop the run game, make Brandon Wimbush make some decisions and some hard throws down the field. Temple has some good cornerbacks. They will be able to cover the Notre Dame wide receivers, put
that pressure on Wimbush. That would be my plan of attack for Temple.
Collins' first game as a head coach, an heir of mystique. He is not named a starting quarterback for today. It's a beautiful day. College football is back. It's the Owls and the Irish kickoff after this.
This has been the U.S. Bank NBC Sports Report.
-72 degrees. What a perfect day for football as we welcome you back to Notre Dame football presented by Bose. Well, there is the eye-catching massive video board, 96 feet long, 54 feet tall. Images of Notre Dame football past and present being shown before the Irish run out of the North Tunnel and take the field for the first time this year. There's new, but Old Faithful still there. The anticipation. These guys have heard all spring and summer how bad last year was. Their first step to try to change it in 2017 is about to arrive. For the first time in 2017, here come the Irish. Brian Kelly's won 59 of his 90 games as the Notre Dame head coach. He begins year 8 today. And for the fifth straight year, it's a different opening day starting quarterback. Brandon Wimbush takes over. Total experience, 2 games of mop-up action in 2015. So all this looks familiar, but there's another new feature in this renovated stadium. There's a separate tunnel for the visitors to run out. And let me tell you, it's really tight. It's claustrophobic in there. They'll trickle out, not run out. But here come the Temple Owls, opening their season in South Bend for the second time in 5 years. First time Jeff Collins has been hired as a head coach at any level. Great place to make your debut as a head coach. The house that Rockne built in South Bend against the Irish, where Brian Kelly is the head coach, and he's standing by on the sidelines as we welcome back Catherine Tappan.
Mike, thank you very much. Coach, you said that you had to hit the reset button after last season. You made a number of changes within the program, but what did you personally do to change?
Well, I think you have to evaluate yourself. You know, obviously an unsuccessful football team, I had to lead better. I had to lead by example, and that is get in here and make the appropriate changes across the board. Again, when it comes to leadership, you start with yourself. And so I think I've made the appropriate changes to be around our football team and much more, put all those other things aside and focus on our football team.
And focusing on your football team means focusing on a new quarterback, Brandon Wimbush, making his first collegiate start today. What do you want to see from him?
You know, just he's a first-time starter. He's going to make mistakes, but you know, just park those mistakes, move on to the next play, and he's an exciting player. I'm excited to watch him. If I can go upstairs with you guys and watch the game, it should be fun.
All right, Coach, thank you very much. Mike, I'm down here. You guys are upstairs. Take it away.
Hey, Brian wants to do a 3-man booth. We're all good, but I've got the Heisman Trophy winner, Doug Flutie, with me. All right, change. That's the theme. What's your view of this Notre Dame team?
I feel like everything's in place for this team to be successful. Chip Long, new offensive coordinator, loves to run the ball. They've got a great offensive line, very experienced, big and strong up front. Extra tight ends to help them out to run the football. And 3 tailbacks that can carry.
All right, Catherine just asked Brian Kelly about it. What's your scouting report on the quarterback?
He hasn't played, so there's a variable there. But he's a bright, mature kid, no doubt about it. Big-time arm, very athletic, can take off and make plays with his feet.
A couple years ago, an opener, Temple and Notre Dame, you'd say blowout Notre Dame. Last couple of years, Temple has college football's attention. Last couple of days, they've gotten our attention as well.
No doubt about it. They walk into meetings with us, the kids, coming off 2 10-win seasons, very confident. They're used to winning. They expect to win. They're not intimidated by this atmosphere at all, coming off a conference championship. They're a defensive-minded team with a defensive-minded head coach.
You get the sense that they are ready for this stage. Remember, a couple of years ago, they were a ranked team in South Bend. When they played Notre Dame, they did not back down at all. So even though it's all new around here and the trappings are special, Temple is ready for this, and so are the Irish, this opening day, 2017, in South Bend. Thank you.
Dropping back deep for the Irish.
Classes have started. Students are back on campus. They're ready to go as well. I'll be wondering what's going through Jeff Collins' mind as well. He faces Brian Kelly. It's his first time ever as a head coach. Never in high school, never D3, never FCS. Irish won the toss. They will receive. And C.J. Sanders took a couple back last year. Will take Aaron Bumeri's kick. It is so good to have football back. Off we go with the 2017 Notre Dame season. Sanders from the goal line. Picks up some blocks, has some space. Sanders pulled down at the 28-yard line. Good acceleration. If that tackle wasn't made, he had a lot of room to run. Well, we've talked a lot about Brandon Wimbush, the quarterback for the Irish, as he takes over this offense and a different offensive coordinator. So, Doug, while we got used to what things looked like as Brian Kelly was the play caller, it may look a little different here today.
Absolutely. You'll probably see more of a run game, play action, not so much drop back passing, and already a couple of tight ends in the game.
And this young man, Wimbush, the 6'1" junior from New Jersey, can run. He's got good wheels. Looking to pass right away. And looking up top, caught by Equanimeous St. Brown, bumped out of bounds at the 38-yard line. Terrific start, a gain of 32 for the top receiver on the Irish.
Watch the inside receiver on the corner route. It's cleared out on the outside. Ball's delivered on time. Pass protection was beautiful. Nice, easy throw to start the game.
Gain of 33, and there goes 33. Josh Adams in the clear. What a start to the season. Touchdown, Notre Dame. You know, if I'm Chip Long, the new offensive coordinator, I drop the mic. I'm done. That's it.
Walk. Done. Two and out.
Well, that is pro potential on those two players. St. Brown, the big catch for 33. The 37-yard run for Josh Adams. Justin Yoon on to add the extra point. And Notre Dame, message sent in 33 seconds.
Left side of the line, we talked about it. Strong offensive line created a nice crease, double teams up front. And Josh Adams has speed as well. He's powerful speed. He's put on some weight. He's much stronger. He does run a little upright, but what a start for the Irish.
We said Brian Kelly's not calling the plays. He is more of a CEO than he was. He's spent most of his time the first 7 years in just the offensive meetings. But he knows exactly what's going on with every facet of this program, and thrilled to see that start for Brandon Wimbush as he went to two of the elite weapons. And Doug, we talked about this watching practice Thursday. There's a lot of pro potential talent on this Notre Dame team. If the quarterback can get them the ball and he can play at a high level, this can be a very explosive offense.
It is not all going to be on Brandon Wimbush. He has tools around him to work with. Strong, talented tight ends, tailbacks that can carry the ball with a big offensive line and a couple explosive receivers.
Yoon is kicking off. It is a short kick and fielded at the six by Adonis Jennings for Temple. He's brought down to the 23-yard line. You're going to see a lot as this day goes on of Julian Love, the cornerback. They're on kickoff coverage. He makes the tackle. So let's meet the Temple offense and who's going to be working around this uncertain quarterback position. Keith Kirkwood's their top receiver. They are missing who should be their number one receiver, Ventel Bryant, out with a hamstring injury. The offensive line's anchored by a redshirt freshman. Matt Hennessy played three games, then with injury couldn't finish the season. So he's able to redshirt, but he's so impressive in the middle there. He's on the Remington Award watch list. That's the award that goes to the best center in the country. And all the hijinks are over. Logan Marchie is going to be the starting quarterback. Redshirt sophomore from Bristol, Connecticut. And Marchie quickly hits Adonis Jennings, the receiver, for a first down to the 40-yard line. So Temple with an immediate response. It was either Frank Neutile, the junior, or Logan Marchie, the sophomore, who was going to start. It is Marchie who, like all the other quarterbacks on this Temple roster, very limited experience. He was the number two man most of last year. Gain of 20 on the first play. They'll run Raquel Armstead to the right, and their top running back gets to the 48-yard line. That's a pickup of about 5. Jonathan Bonner made the tackle on that Notre Dame defense. His front seven has to be better, plain and simple. Dalen Hayes, the sophomore, is going to be a big pass rush impact man. Solid in the linebacking core, including Niles Morgan, the senior. In the secondary, I'll be very honest with you, they're very worried about the safety play. If they're good back there, they may be good all year. Here's Armstead to the left. That time he stopped, just a gain of 2 yards, as Jay Hayes, the senior from Brooklyn, made the tackle.
Well, this Temple team has a heck of a fullback in Nick Sharga. Watch number 4 come off the edge. Now, this is 2 plays in a row. He's put a guy on the ground, creates the seam for the running back, Armstead. He is a legitimate big-time fullback, and there aren't many in college football.
Kenny Yeboah, the tight end, was the motion man. That fullback takes the carry that time, and Sharga bulls his way for the first down in Irish territory at the 46-yard line.
Most of Sharga's carries are in short yardage, picking up first downs. That's the way it is for him. It's kind of neat to finally see a college football game with a real fullback and 2-back sets, and even Notre Dame with the extra tight ends sometimes use them as fullbacks. It's power football.
I figured to see much more running in this game today. Here's the guy running a lot, Armstead. Good carry on first down. That's a gain of about 6 yards. Notre Dame has a new defensive coordinator in Mike Elko. They struggled with Brian Van Gorder, let go during last season. They must be better on this side of the ball, plain and simple. On 2nd and 4, Marchie, the quarterback, everything's covered, and a sack. It is Julian Okwara with the sack. It took Notre Dame 3.5 games to get a sack last year. Here they get one in the first half dozen plays of the season.
Okwara just pushes Boozer back, creates some separation, goes underneath and gets the sack. Quarterback had to hold the ball a little bit due to coverage downfield. A lot of zone on first and second down in coverage. Make this quarterback read.
Notre Dame goes 5 defensive backs here. Inexperienced quarterback Marchie with 3rd and 8. Put 4 in the pattern and throw incomplete. And a twist and turn. Broderick Yancey, his receiver, around. You'll see more of Yancey because Ventel Bryant is out with a hamstring injury. But 4th down at the 44, they'll kick it away.
Well, they have a shot here. There's separation over the top, but because it's man coverage, you have to make a tight throw. There was a blitz coming, a little pressure on the quarterback, and it's an errant throw off the mark on 3rd down. I would expect to see a lot of man coverage on 3rd down to get off the field for Notre Dame's defense.
That's Chris Fink back deep. Alex Starzit, who was suspended for a good part of the preseason, is back with the Temple program. He's a good kicker. Sure-handed punt return man in Fink. Fair catch at the 13. So Notre Dame stops Temple on their opening drive, and the Irish offense back on the field. 2 plays, 1 touchdown. Notre Dame football is brought to you by Coca-Cola Zero Sugar. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero sugar, zero calories. By Mercedes-Benz, the best or nothing. By Bose, get closer. And by U.S. Bank. Get a look at Notre Dame Stadium over the years here on campus, and the additions now, really 3 buildings on 3 of the 4 sides here surrounding the old bowl, but nothing old about that. Just a spectacular new set of vantage points. That video board that's attracted so much attention. The video board, it's a beautiful sunshiny day, and you can see how crystal clear it is. It is one of the finest in the country. It just still feels like Notre Dame Stadium, but the modern touches are around, and the fans enjoying it. And they enjoyed their Irish offense. 2 plays and a touchdown to get started. This drive starts at their own 14. And Wimbush gives. It's Adams who had the touchdown run a moment ago. Only 1 yard there. So you've already met Josh Adams. The best of 3 backs you're going to see as the day goes on. And Equanimeous St. Brown. Want to call your attention to the tight ends, too. Working with St. Brown in the past game, they have 5 really good ones. Second team preseason All-American Mike McGlinchey is the left tackle. Quentin Nelson's a first team All-American at left guard. They're really good over there. And on that side, Adams twists and turns for a 1st down run out to the 26-yard line before Mike Jones spills him.
Adding to that offensive line is number 72, Robert Hainsey. He's actually in the game right now at right tackle. A little more, a little better in pass pro, and Kramer maybe a little better in the run game.
There's one spot that was very important in this preseason camp and a tight battle throughout. Wimbush throws incomplete, looking for Alize Mack, the tight end who was coming across. Safety Sean Chandler was in coverage. Here's Doug. This guy hasn't been hit. Wimbush hasn't played in a game in 2 years. Nearly played 30 snaps in those two mop-up games. So he was excited just for somebody to hit him so he can feel part of the game again.
You could see it all spring and all training camp that he wants to take off and run and show his legs off, and he hasn't had that opportunity. He has to tuck the ball away when he runs, though. He has not been hit.
Well, he got pressured there and nearly turned into an interception. The linebacker Sam Franklin was in coverage on the tight end. It'll be 3rd and 10.
Little pressure in his face, trying to make a tight throw. The ball's a little bit behind, creates an opportunity for an interception. That was caused by the pressure in his face. Now in 3rd and long, Brandon Wimbush not as comfortable being in the pocket and looking upfield, reading the whole field, and that's this type of situation.
And 3rd down, the pressure is picked up, and Wimbush fires incomplete, high and overthrowing Equanimeous St. Brown. So after 1 first down, the Irish will punt it away. This is a Temple defense that will give problems to Brian Kelly's offense as the day goes on, if they can get a little bit of pass rush going there, because they've got two good safeties and a couple of guys who can change the game off the edges.
I mean, the whole secondary can cover man coverage, safeties included, so they're not afraid to bring pressure and get after the quarterback.
That's one of the safeties we talk about, Sean Chandler. He's back deep to catch Tyler Newsom's punt. 3rd year for the senior from Georgia. Very nice kick. It all Charles 54 yards and back of the 20. It's Chandler. Nowhere to go. Love tripped him up. And other gold helmets coming to clean him up. As two good special teams plays by Julian Love. The eventual tackle will be credited to Notre Dame's Greer Martini, the linebacker. We mentioned Jeff Collins, the new head coach at Temple, replacing Matt Rhule, who took over at Baylor. Give you an idea where he's been. On the defensive side of the ball is his pedigree. Was around Nick Saban at Alabama. Then a defensive coordinator, including the last 6 years in the SEC at Mississippi State and Florida. Like his nickname, Doug, the Minister of Mayhem.
It just, that infers we're coming air for you, bringing the blitz. And like I just said, the safeties on that can play man coverage too. So they're not afraid.
There's an intensity about it. We garnered that as we were meeting with him yesterday.
Snap infraction, offense, number 58, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Matt Hennessy, the center who we lauded when we gave you the starting lineups, called for that infraction.
In talking to him, the intensity you were talking about, he likes to change things up in practice, does everything in a unique way. We call them hitting during pregame.
I mean, it was two guys going after it in a circle. 1st and 15. Well, Armstead on the top. He's brought down. Good play by Drew Tranquil. He came up from the rover spot. That's a different change on this Notre Dame defense. It really, Doug, is going to look a little bit more like a 4-2-5 this year.
Right. Instead of having 3 linebackers, it's only 2, and kind of a 5th defensive back/linebacker position that creates the opportunity to stay out there in nickel situations. Makes it very diverse.
Armstead again, and the man who starts right next to Tranquil over there, Daylon Hayes on the defensive line, comes up with a big play. It'll be 3rd down. Catherine, what about that captain on defense, Drew Tranquil?
Well, he told me the biggest difference for him from strong safety last year is being down in the run game more. That he has to put his vision, which is different last year at safety when he had to key his key and the vision of the quarterback. This year he's closer to the line and at the linebacker level. He said he just has to have better peripheral vision, which has really been his biggest adjustment, he said, Mike.
And he can stay on the field in these situations, Tap, and there's less running guys on and off for Notre Dame. 3rd and 12 is 3rd and 17. I believe Temple moved early.
5-yard penalty. Third down.
Cole Boozer, the right tackle. Guilty party there. So this is not the start this offense wanted. One good possession, one good play on their opening possession, I should say, Doug. But Logan Marchi, lit experience, redshirt sophomore quarterback, backed up with 3rd and 17. From the 15, the Irish run for, what a move by Hayes. He leapt over the tackle, and the pass is incomplete. That is not exactly your trademark pass rush move from the soft Dalen Hayes. Wow.
This is the one guy that has some pass rush moves and some athleticism. Out to the right, coming off the edge. Dalen Hayes just hurdles, hands down. The back, Armstead goes for the cut. He's too far away. He sees it, puts the hands down, up and over, and pressure on the quarterback.
You want to cut me and go for my knees? I'll take care of that. Alex Starzik to kick it away to Chris Fink. Pretty good rugby punter. It's 43 as Fink takes it on the bounce of the 42. He's got some blocking but couldn't get to that wall that was being set up as the Owls covered it well. Jacob Martin, part of the group, with tackle for Jeff Collins' Temple team. Good field position for the Irish when we come back to South Bend. Download the NBC Sports app to watch thousands of live sporting events. Stream for free with your NBCSN subscription. For details, visit NBCSports.com/live. Here, the Golden Dome, South Bend, Notre Dame, Indiana. And there's Brandon Wimbush. Boy, when you play this position, there is attention. And people know what comes with being the Notre Dame quarterback. So did he. Very talented prep player in New Jersey. State champion, best player in this in 2014. Originally committed to Penn State, recruited by some other big schools, but committed to Notre Dame at the end of the recruiting process. Only played against UMass and Pitt in 2015. Didn't play at all last year as Deshaun Kaiser and Malik Zaire were here, and Wimbush gets spun and pinballed around after a gain of about 7 yards on that keeper. That is one of the things he does well, but that's that first hit we've talked about. It didn't look like it was a fun hit to take.
No, exactly. He's been wishing to get hit for about 9 months now, and he took a little shot, spun to the ground, but I think Chip Long actually called that intentionally, get a chance to break a sweat, get hit, get into the physical part of the game.
Sam Franklin was happy to oblige. This is a zone read that Wimbush keeps, accelerates, and has a first down inside the 40 at the Temple 38-yard line. Gain of 13 for the quarterback. Mentioned Deshaun Kaiser, who was the Notre Dame quarterback the bulk of last year. He will be the starter at Cleveland Browns a week from tomorrow against Pittsburgh. He's come over the four-hour drive. He's on the sidelines talking with Notre Dame Athletic Director Jack Swerk, among others. Nice to be an NFL quarterback and come back and have everybody see you. There's a flag in here on this carry. Deshaun Bradley for Temple makes the tackle on Adams.
Personal foul. Hands in the face. Defense. Number 72. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Temple cannot afford that. Quentin Nelson, the first team All-American guard, was the player being blocked by Karamo Diabate. Left side
right at the end, hand up under the face mask there, pushing up and over the pile. It's the play's over. Don't take 15. You can't afford. It's going to be tough enough to stop this running attack.
We mentioned the good defense from Notre Dame left a short field. The Irish taking advantage of it. Here's Cameron Smith. Coming around from his receiver position, Smith, one of two graduate transfers into the program this year. He played at Arizona State and gives them great variety. He and Freddie Canteen, 15 and 11. They're both at the top of the screen now. Canteen came from Michigan, Smith from Arizona State. They've added experience to this receiving corps. Wimbush takes a hit and he'll lose a yard as buzzing up from that safety spot was Delvon Randall. He's the player who told us last night, it's not a big game because we're at Notre Dame. It's a big game because we're in it.
Really, the run through by Graham Mobley from the backside caused the aggravation and kept Wimbush from getting to the outside. Randall with a nice tap on the outside.
Notre Dame has good tight ends. It allows them to split them out. Alize Mack is out there to block for Smith. He's not going to get much. He'll get to the 7-yard line here. That second down play is limited and we'll get third down coming up.
As you said, with the tight ends in the situation in this area of the field, they become very big. Alize Mack actually on the first on the first play was one-on-one on the outside, which looks like a formation on first down they may go to later.
We got a couple of tight ends in there and Equanimeous St. Brown and Chase Claypool, so they've got 6'4", 6'5", 6'4", 6'5" is the four
just
receivers.
Throw it up.
Great red zone advantage for the quarterback.
Wimbush asking for motion, not getting it. Third and goal. Temple's coming. Wimbush stays alive, stays on his feet, and takes it to the end zone. Touchdown, Notre Dame. And that's what mobility can do for you.
Initially, he wanted a guy in motion coming from his right. He's a little confused, but he knows he has to snap the ball. So obviously, there's confusion within the route. He did have a shot at the tight end on a corner route, but he finally gets to use his legs and take off and run and extend plays, which is what he will do very well.
We want the left side of the line. Let's credit 71 Alex Bars, the right guard, held his block. Wimbush found that little alley to run. Justin Yoon adds the extra point. 28 yards on the ground on that drive for Brandon Wimbush, the name to get to know. Notre Dame's new quarterback having a very good first quarter in his first start. Looking forward to this show this fall. Anywhere in the world where Americans are at risk, one team brings them home. The Brave, new series premieres September 25th on NBC. Mike Tirico, Doug Flutie, Catherine Tappan here at Notre Dame Stadium. Been a terrific start for Brandon Wimbush. First time as the Notre Dame starting quarterback. First three drives, two touchdowns, doing it with his legs on that drive. And the Irish, less than 10 minutes into the season, have a two-touchdown lead on the Temple Owls. Kickoff comes down to Adonis Jennings. Returns it to the left again. He's over the 20 to the 23-yard line. Tony Jones, the backup running back, made the tackle. There's a new defensive coordinator for the Irish. We mentioned Mike Elko's name. He's been a defensive coordinator, Doug, for quite some time, considering he's only 40 years old, 13 years in his career. The last eight, he was at Bowling Green and at Wake Forest with Dave Clawson.
Has the reputation for causing turnovers. Wake Forest in the top three in the nation in turnover margin or turnovers last year, as well as putting pressure on the quarterback. And he did it at Wake. He should be able to do it here at Notre Dame.
As we mentioned, pressuring the quarterback was a problem for the Irish last year, just 14 sacks. Logan Margie remains the Temple quarterback. There's a thought the Owls may see multiple quarterbacks here. Three drives, all three with Marchie. He's got a new running back, David Hood, who runs to the right and only gets about 2 yards. Tackle made by Jay Hayes, who was part of that defense that, candidly, Doug, was not very good last year. When you look at where the Irish ranked, it was not where this team needs to be.
I mean, it took them to the fourth game to get a sack. The amount of points they were allowing, no pressure, and already we have we've seen a sack and a couple of pressures tonight. Today.
Five on the defensive line here as Marchie gets pressured. His pass is complete. Good job by Isaiah Wright to avoid the tackle. We'll get the first down across the 35-yard line. Tavon Coney in on it for the Irish.
Coney coming through clean. A mistake in the offensive line. They had enough people to pick him up, but he came flying. Great job of Marchie getting the ball out quickly. That's what I call chuck and duck. Turn that shoulder, protect yourself. You know the ball is gone. Nice completion on a play where there was no blitz pickup.
It's a technical term.
Technical. Oh, yeah. All my terms are technical.
Chuck and duck. Just past the 35. Marchie throwing the out. It floats in the air, but into the hands of Isaiah Wright. Good pass and catch into Notre Dame territory at the 39-yard line. A pickup of 24 in front of the safety, Nick Coleman.
Great job of Wright of maintaining his balance coming out of the break. Markey's eyes went out to the outside and both guys break on it, but right in his pattern, tripped, stumbled, stayed on his feet, was able to make the catch.
Wright plays many roles for this Temple team, so he was a Wildcat quarterback at times last year. This is Hood cutting it back. He's tripped up. Nice job by Jonathan Bonner. Second time we've called the senior from Chesterfield, Missouri on the defensive stop for the Irish.
He's a guy that's been changing positions throughout his career at Notre Dame and now finding himself as a nose guard, nose tackle, down lineman.
Marchie seems to be settling in a bit on time and on target with his tight end Kenny Yeboah for a first down. That's the 25-yard line. Nick Coleman again on the stop.
But Temple keeping the chains moving, best looking drive of this opening quarter.
Marchi gets a lot of, he's getting a lot of zone coverage on first down. He's making quick decisions and getting the ball out of his hands. I like his rhythm and how quickly he's making the decision and getting it out.
His top running back, Raquel Armstead, back in the game. Notre Dame showing blitz, bringing heat, shot downfield. Best receivers, Keith Kirkwood. Contact, no call. Incomplete as Kirkwood was being defended by Julian Love.
Love may have gotten away with a little tug and a pull there down as the ball was in the air. But again, pressure. This is all out blitz coming after you. Great job of stepping in and getting rid of the ball and taking the hit, though. Notre Dame brings a full man, this full pressure, man-to-man coverage on the back end. Love holds up. There's a little bit of contact going on down the field.
But the officials are going to let that hand fighting go a little bit. Are you being denied the opportunity to get to the ball? Didn't look like it there. Armstead on the run. Good counter for a gain of 6 yards as the tackle is made by Devin Studstill. He's a backup at one of those safety positions for the Irish. Studstill, sophomore from Florida. He had 9 starts last year as there was injuries in the search for answers on this Irish defense. He remains on the field for 3rd and 4.
Again, in third down situations like this, I'd expect man-to-man coverage, bring a little pressure.
Irish changing the defensive look. Marchi throw an end zone, nothing there. As Nick Watkins had that shutdown, it's the best Irish corner against the best available Temple receiver in Keith Kirkwood. Again, their top receiver, Ventel Bryant, out with a hamstring injury. So Temple will try to get on the board with a field goal. Austin Jones tore his ACL after a kickoff last year in the game against Memphis. Aaron Bumeri, who you saw kick off for the Owls earlier, came in and did a very good job the remainder of the season. But Jones's rehab, that leg where he tore the ACL, is even stronger. And he's back on the field, the senior, kicking from 36 yards. And it's got to feel good after all the rehab he did to knock that field goal through for the first points of his Temple season. So Jeff Collins' team is on the board. 14-3 Notre Dame. Major League game in primetime next Saturday night as the Georgia Bulldogs come to South Bend. So rare to see an SEC team here. Only one in the last 17 years have come to Notre Dame. It's a Georgia team with Kirby Smart year two, the terrific running combination of Nick Chubb, Sony Michel. They open up tonight against Appalachian State. 10 years and a day after App State made a name for itself in Ann Arbor. A short kick is fair caught. Notre Dame has 3 tight ends lined up there as that line before the kick returners. So you want a pooch kick? That's fine. Durham Smythe with the catch there, and the Irish take over at the 28. What a first quarter, Doug, for Brandon Wimbush.
He had a chance to get comfortable right away. Play action on the first play of the game. Look at the pocket so he can set his feet, deliver the ball down the field, and get comfortable. Then he does a great job on the zone read, reads the contained player crashing down, pulls the ball out and takes off. So now he's an athlete. And then to get in the end zone, it's pure athleticism because he's a little confused with motion formation, didn't see it cleanly, says the heck with it, I'll take it myself.
You see he's been active so far as 2 backs in the game to start this drive. This is Josh Adams, the main back, and Temple does a nice job up front to make the stop. No gain there. Tony Jones Jr. See Dexter Williams at some point as this season goes on. So this is the talent we talk about around Wimbush. There are some really good players. If the quarterback's on, this can be as potent an offense as anyone in the country.
His job is going to be to distribute the ball and then use his legs.
No gain. Jones in motion. Adams the run. Oh, he breaks free. Look out for Josh Adams. Temple pursuing from behind. Adams at the 30 and the 20. They've got the angle on him, but take him out of bounds at the 12-yard line. Sean Chandler all the way across the field for the stop, but a huge run of 60 yards for Josh Adams.
He's put on a little weight, a little bit stronger, shakes off a tackle and takes off. He still has the speed. Great job up front. He gets one little arm. That arm tackle is not going to bring him down.
But Nelson, the guard, the All-American, with a terrific block to create that opening. This time Wimbush pulls it down, puts it up top to the end zone. Caught for the Nick Wisher touchdown.
This is a strike. He can't break contain off the bootleg action. The quick throw's not there, so he puts his foot in the ground, turns around, snaps his hips.
Oh,
and boom, a laser right on the money, because that was tight coverage. Nice job by Franklin. The ball was just on the money.
A terrific throw. We've talked about Wimbush and all the things he does. Maybe didn't spend enough time talking about that laser arm he has. And you hear a lot of Durham Smythe and Alizé Mack and the freshman tight ends that are here for Notre Dame. The senior Nick Wisher with that touchdown grab. Justin Yoon with a happy first quarter. Three extra points. Irish offense, a terrific start. Wimbush with a rocket. Wisher the catch. 21-3 ND. Wimbush had the rushing touchdown for the second Irish score. That's his touchdown pass there to Nick Wisher. As Notre Dame takes a 21-3 lead as Wisher gets his first career touchdown reception.
And it's good to see that. You know, senior year, all the talk about the young freshmen coming and the talent they have at that position. And he was the lost guy. He's done a lot of the dirty work at tight end over the last couple of years in different situations and run formations. And he finally gets to get in the end zone.
Yoon kicking off, and this time no return from Mike Jones or Adonis Jennings. The Temple will take over at the 25-yard line. This program was about done a decade ago. Temple football was really in bad shape. It was a bad decade plus. No winning seasons. They won one out of every five games. But a real resurgence starting in 2009. Four bowl appearances in that time. I mentioned Matt Rhule, who's now at Baylor, did a lot of that work at the most recent. As a matter of fact, you compare these two teams the last 2 years. Temple's the one that has 20 wins, its best two-year run. And Jeff Collins said this job was attractive. It used to be the Temple job you'd only get when it was 0-11, 1-10. But because of the recent build of this program, this was an attractive job. And Matt Rhule was a very good friend of Jeff Collins. So Collins felt like he knew exactly what he was getting into and wanted this job. 25 marching, straight option. Raquel Armstead gets the edge and gets 7 yards. Before a busy Devin Studstill makes the tackle.
I see a little bit of everything out of Marchie at quarterback. That was a true option. Ran right at Drew Tranquil, made the guy take him, takes a pitch on the outside. Great first down game.
Went to St. Paul Catholic in Bristol, Connecticut. Six-footer, played in 5 games last year, led one scoring drive, but Philip Walker was the man for Temple in terms of quarterback the last 4 years. That time, nowhere for Armstead to go. Drew Tranquil, who Catherine told you about earlier, adjusting to his new position, all over that. And we'll have third and long as this quarter gets to the end.
Tranquil just comes up the field in a hurry. He read in a hurry. He's playing fast from that Rover position. This defense has been simplified somewhat, and the talk on the defensive side of the ball is that they are trusting their read, trusting the defense, and playing fast.
No reason to rush a play here. Temple needs to get collected. You got third down and 5 coming up. Do it on the other side. Second quarter. Irish defense are run down by the student section. They've seen a really good opening quarter. After one, it's Notre Dame 21 and Temple 3. We'll return to Notre Dame Stadium after these messages from your local NBC station. You're watching Notre Dame football on NBC, presented by Bose. Picture postcard Saturday in South Bend. Glad you're with us. Notre Dame Saturday on NBC. Mike Tirico, Doug Flutie, Catherine Tappan. Dream start for the Irish after the 4-8 season, up 21-3
on a Temple team that's won 10 games each of the last 2 years. Logan Margie, 3rd and 5, and his pass incomplete as he tried to get it to Isaiah Wright. And again, Dalen Hayes rushing, tried to jump over the running back who was going to cut him at the line of scrimmage.
Again, Notre Dame bringing pressure on third down. Watch from the top of the screen. Push, jumping again is Hayes. That's Okwara putting pressure on the quarterback, making him release the ball early. Tight man coverage, you could still complete that pass, but because of pressure, it's tough in third down situations. You got to stand in there and deliver that ball and get the conversion, because Temple can find themselves way out of this game if that continues. That was a very important conversion.
Down could rush it, Alex Starzik. He gets away a high hanger. 45, 46 yards. And Chris Fink will make the fair catch. It's been a long time since we've had a Notre Dame Saturday without knowing Ara Parsegian was watching. He passed away in early August at 94 years old. What a great coach, what a great man. Led Notre Dame to 2 national championships, 1966, 1973. In 11 seasons, his record was 95, 17, and 4. The warmth and a connection with people, in addition to being such a great coach. Brian Kelly said, a remarkable man, truly unique. You see T-shirts, the protection of the goalpost, even on the helmets. Ara's name is there and present, and his presence will be part of Notre Dame football this season and, of course, beyond. Irish drive starts at 24. He just scored a touchdown. Josh Adams this time. He is stopped for no game. Jacob Martin from the defensive end spot with tackle. It's kind of weird to be in a Notre Dame game. Brian Kelly's not calling the plays. That's the guy who is, Doug, 34-year-old Chip Long, who was last at Memphis. The time at Louisville, the influence of Bobby Petrino, that really set his foundation in offense at Illinois with Ron Zook, at Arizona State as well, with Todd Graham. He's now calling the plays of the Irish in Wimbush, who finds Alize Mack, the tight end, who takes it to the 33-yard line, a yard shy of the first down.
Alize Mack is a guy that is going to be a big variable at tight end. He's going to create mismatches for this offense. He can block like a tight end. You can line him up wide and run real downfield routes. He's got speed and size. He's coming back off a suspension from last year, an academic suspension, and is extremely excited about this season. Talk about tight ends.
You got 3 of them on the field to the left there as Adams runs for the first down to the 35-yard line. And, Doug, that's one of the things that Chip Long can do. Even though he was at Memphis and spread it out, they were a top 20 passing offense. He is very happy using multiple tight end formations as this season goes on.
He had 3 of them set all to the left there and an opportunity to run the football. Look at all 3 guys to the left side, 2 off the ball. It's like having extra fullbacks in run formations.
Fake to Jones, keep Wimbush in the open field. Wimbush makes a man miss across midfield into Temple territory at a first down at the 48-yard line. Gain of 18 that time.
Stepping out of tackles, again, reading zone read. That was more like Brandon Wimbush running with the football. We saw him slide down a little earlier. I think he's been coached to be a little bit careful.
Mm-hmm.
But once he gets into the flow of the game, that's not going to happen.
Dovon Randall, the outstanding safety for Temple, not out there. Benny Walls is the other safety right now. Wimbush with a great arm, put it up top. Caught by St. Brown. Equanimeous St. Brown read it in the air, came back to the ball, matched up on a linebacker, and dusted him. Gain of 33.
Sharif Finch with the pressure right in his face. Wimbush coming off a fake, a naked bootleg, comes out, takes the hit, throwing off balance. Puts it 40 yards downfield and lets his receiver make a play.
Sam Franklin, the strong side linebacker, that's not what he's supposed to be doing. He just got caught defensively. Good stop on the run by Tony Jones Jr. Just a yard before Benny Walls makes the tackle. Sharif Finch, who you just mentioned, Doug, it's one of the best players up front for this Temple team, a guy who can make a game-changing play. He just checked out of the Owls lineup. As they are desperate for a stop here. Run right. Jones keeps the feet moving. Look at that pile being pushed by Notre Dame's big offensive line to take it down to the 10-yard line.
The rugby scrum. These offensive linemen love this opportunity. I've seen it over the last few years where they all come join the party. Start pushing. Stay on your feet. They'll hold the runner up so they can continue to push.
Alex Barr's got going there on the right side. He's 71. He's a senior. 78 is Tommy Kramer. That's the position we're watching closely. Right tackle for the Irish. Third and six. Wimbush looking right. Pass incomplete on a contact with St. Brown and the corner Artrell Foster. Wimbush got hit as he threw it. And he got roughed.
He stood in there and tried to deliver the ball, though, and the pressure comes from the middle and also off the edge a little bit, but it's all coming, and it's man-to-man coverage. He gets rid of the football. Little smack to the head with the hand.
Yeah, Julian Taylor, watched by Wimbush's helmet right there, and then the push in the face mask to knock him down. Is Temple tough, and that's one thing, but Temple not smart on that play because we limited Notre Dame to a field goal attempt. Instead, it's first and goal at the five.
There is a fine line between that intensity on defense and playing through the whistle and then getting personal fouls.
For the two tight end set for the Irish. St. Brown in the corner, spins around, collects the ball. Touchdown, Notre Dame. Equanimeous St. Brown with his first of the season.
He's one-on-one out there with Linwood Crump. And really, it was good coverage on the play, but good ball placement over the outside shoulder. He does a center field turn to find the ball, catches it over the opposite shoulder, and pulls it in. That's knowing you have an athlete out there that's pretty tall, and you're just going to put it up and let him make a play for you.
Well, St. Brown led this team. He's the offensive player of the year for the Irish last year, the leader of that wide receiving corps with 9 touchdowns. Fans murmur Yoon as Justin Yoon adds the extra point and another solid drive for the Irish. They've scored on 4 of their 5 drives to start the season. Wimbush in all 3 passes on that drive for 48 yards. The last 5 to St. Brown, 28-3, Notre Dame. Notre Dame football is brought to you by State Farm, here to help life go right. By Walmart, save money, live better. By Verizon, not just unlimited, Verizon Unlimited. And by Edward Jones, where attention and sound advice is a big deal. It's a big deal, all the changes that are made around the stadium, and you can take hours and not see all of it. And maybe as you watch the game, other than the video board, it's hard to see, unless you think back to the 60s and the 70s when it was just the bowl. But these edges of the buildings, the suites that are out here now, and also for the fans inside, the benches have been replaced, more restrooms, the concourses are great, Art Deco look, some of the memories of Notre Dame football, just every detail done, terrific. Touchback there, Mike Elko's defense. So far, Doug, so good.
Passing the test, they needed to find some pass rush. Julian Aguirre gets a good push up and under. Quarterback had to hold the ball a little bit. Brings him down for the first sack of the season. Drew Tranquil playing fast and strong. Throws his man off, comes in to make the tackle. He's playing fast to the ball, so is Dalen Hayes. Eyes are in the backfield reading. He has been athletic in the pass rush as well tonight.
Mike Elko trying to create pressure. You don't even necessarily have those guys up front who are going to dominate the game on the D line. So a little bit of what he's trying to do. Jagger Gardner is the running back for Temple as Logan Marchi rolls a first down throw to Kirkwood, complete. Kirkwood right in front of Julian Love with the grab at the 41-yard line, a pickup of 16 in a first down.
Nice little route by Kirkwood. They have explosive receivers. Temple receivers are dangerous. And Marchi, I tell you, he can throw the football. He's finding targets as far as he needs pass protection.
Move man's Kenny Yeboah, the tight end. Try to set the edge for the run by Jagger Gardner. Bounced one outside, a good pursuit tackle by Nick Coleman up from his safety spot. Seen the safeties get involved in the run defense here significantly for the Irish.
Well, it's a concern on the defensive side of the ball is the safety position. So if you're running and filling on the run plays, the play action is where they've been getting burnt. The play action is where you have to have discipline enough to stay back and have your responsibility in the pass game.
Christian Temple came to South Bend to open the season 2013.
They lost that game 28-6. Played well in that game. A couple of key mistakes did not let them get the offense going. And then on Halloween night a few years ago in Philly, had a terrific game with the Irish. Jagger Gardner on the run again. He'll be a couple of yards shy of the first down. And that game in 2015, when Temple was ranked, it was the most anticipated game in Temple history. It really gave the players who are still here confidence and belief that they could hang with the Irish. They could play on the same field with Notre Dame. They have not been able to get off to a good start, and Temple fans are realizing how much Philip Walker did for them offensively in his 4 years as a starter. Third and two, Gardner bounces to the outside, gets the first down and more. Gardner to the 41-yard line before Irish captain Niles Morgan spills him a gain of 9.
Nick Sharga at number 4, he's the fullback, is a legit fullback. He has had his man on the ground every play. Nice, this time he decides to cut instead of staying high. Ball bounced outside, easy first down. He's put his man he's responsible for on the ground the last 3 plays in a row.
Terrific fullback, doesn't speak much, but he plays a mean guitar. Jeff Collins told us last night, he does his talking with his guitar solos. Big marching, gonna take a shot downfield. Everything was covered, so he just benches it, gets rid of it, and incomplete. How about this, though? You want to talk about guys who like to have fun? So there's a great energy at Temple practice. So Sharga was sent up by the coach. Just go play guitar as the guys are warming up. Break the monotony of camp.
Looking like Slash there from Guns N' Roses with the hair. And
look at him.
I'll tell you what. Go get him, Slash.
That's
great. Awesome.
Leon Johnson's offensive lineman was loving it in dances. A little bit of what Nick Sharga does. They think he's as good a fullback as there is in the country. 3.8 GPA, chemical engineer.
Coached by the head coach.
Yeah, that's right. Give you some licks on the electric guitar and a fullback. Sharga gives it everything. Pretty good player. Nice jump cut there by Armstead. Well, Armstead with a run to the 33-yard line. Catherine, what about Sharga?
Well, he's also one of 11 kids, guys, so maybe he had to differentiate himself a little bit, learn how to play the guitar, but he's also wearing a single digit there, number 4. He said he's really proud about that. He transferred from a Division II school, West Virginia Wesleyan. He knew he wasn't going to play that year that he transferred, but he was grinding it out on the scout team, trying to make an impact, and he earned the single digit jersey while playing on that scout team. So he said he was proud that his teammates thought enough of him and his work ethic to award him with that, even before he ever took a down for Temple. Guys.
And before he even brought out the guitar, too, Catherine. It's great stuff. Third and two. He's in there to carry this time, and he pushes the pile right to the line. We'll see if they got the first down at the 31-yard line. Spot looks like he's got it. So you see some of the versatility for Sharga. You know, Catherine, Doug mentioned the single digits. You'll notice Temple players are at 1 through 9. Everybody's got a single digit. It's a very special part of this program. It's a holdover from the last era. It shows a toughness. It shows leadership. And when you get a single digit at Temple, that means you are a special player. You have a penalty flag thrown here as the Owls are trying to break the huddle.
Substitution. Offense. 12 men on the field. 5-yard penalty.
One too many single digits on the field will cost them a single digit. It'll cost them 5 yards.
Well, you see those single digits from our perspective, and right away there's a light that goes on and says, hey, this is one of their marquee guys, and we pay attention to it. Makes our job a little easier to find the marquee players.
It's true. It started with Al Golden, and he was really, before Matt Rhule, the guy who got Temple football righted. He did it in 2009. He said a lot of high school players had single digits. He wanted to keep the tradition going. Steve Adazio after that. His pass incomplete, as it was intended down the middle. Adazio did away with it. Steve, the Boston College coach. Your alma mater got a win last night against Northern Illinois late at night. The noise I heard down the hallway, you watching the game. But one of the first things Matt Rhule did now 5 years ago when he came back, he brought that tradition back, and Jeff Collins was happy to continue it. And he is taking great care in the ones that he has given. Only a few were left, and the players knew they came from him and really from the heart of the new head coach to signify toughness. Keith Kirkwood, the receiver number 5, was the first one that Collins gave a single digit to. Second and 15. It is a good run by Armstead. Spins for the first down. So despite the first down penalty, Armstead beat that little pressure from the safety and had an opening to take it into the red zone.
Keep an eye on the left side of the line and the fullback again. Here's Leon Johnson on the outside.
I'll tell you what, Chaga, good. Putting this guy on the ground every time, every time.
17 for Quell Armstead. Temple trying to get its opening touchdown of the season here. Really need to come away with some points. I like Armstead's shiftiness and cutback ability there. Gain of 7 on that one. And Temple's left tackle, Leon Johnson, is slow to get up. He's not getting up at all. He looked at by the athletic training staff.
Boy, he was really looking forward to this game as well.
Richard Senior, who came back from multiple surgeries on his shoulder last year to be one of the better players for Jeff Collins. The coaches can go to check on him as we hit this timeout. That's good to see. Leon Johnson's on the sidelines. Athletic training staff not around him. Mentioned that he had multiple shoulder surgeries last year. Kind of looked at that. Watch him come down on that right shoulder. Checked under those shoulder pads. Everything seemed to be okay. So he's out for the moment. Jalen Robinson, junior from New Haven, Connecticut, is in. It's 2nd and 3. Good drive was going for Logan Marchie. He's back in the air to the end zone. Held on to by Kirkwood. And Temple has a touchdown. Keith Kirkwood. Ends a very long drive as Temple gets on the board.
This is a bootleg action where he's going to roll right, trying to fool the defense, and then throw back left. Julian Love's in great position. Kirkwood just goes up and makes the play on the ball. It didn't fool him. He broke back in good coverage, but Kirkwood's big body goes up and makes the play.
It's a terrific adjustment by Kirkwood, too. He came out of that break. The ball was back the other way, had a corkscrew around. Good hands. Marchie has thrown a touchdown pass for the first time in his Temple career. And it is 28-10 as Austin Jones adds the extra point. The reason to cheer for the gang back in Philadelphia as it's an 18-point game. Time now for top performances brought to you by Mercedes-Benz. Alluded to it earlier, the meeting here 5 years ago yesterday. Tommy Reese, as he was known at the time, a couple of touchdowns in the first quarter for Notre Dame. And then a 66-yarder to Troy Nicholas in the second, put it away. Irish won 28-6. Tommy Reese threw for 346 yards as a Notre Dame opening game record and 3 touchdowns. Tommy Reese now goes by Tom Reese, and he is the quarterback coach for Notre Dame. So it's a great opportunity for that position to be coached by somebody who did the job recently, Doug, from 2010 to 2013 while Brian Kelly was here. And what an advantage it is for Brandon Wimbush to have Reese around as his position coach.
An instant credibility for Tom Reese as a coach because some of his stuff is still in the system that these kids are learning from. And he's able to go through things. He's also had to deal with Brian Kelly on the sideline and can relate to the kids in that manner.
C.J. Sanders with a return for the Irish, and he will be stopped before he gets to the 20-yard line. So a little good turnaround here for Temple, getting themselves back in this game. What's your headline so far watching Notre Dame?
I think it's the offensive line and the power football part of it. The passing game has made the big plays and Brandon Wimbush's legs, but the dominance of an offensive line, and then on the flip side, the defense putting pressure.
This is a different offense. We knew that coming in. What have you seen so far that you like about maybe a difference from the Brian Kelly offense with the additions now that Chip Long has brought in?
Well, I think the use of the tight end position, so you do have a legitimate two-back running game. Early in the game, there was 2-to-1 run-to-pass ratio. So they're running the ball a lot more, and it sets up bigger plays in the play-action game.
Josh Adams there for only 2 yards. You just sense a slight, very slight change in momentum here. Temple has nothing going on the defensive side. The Irish have scored touchdowns on 4 of their first 5 possessions. But that sustained drive at least took the pressure off for the moment. Felt like Notre Dame was on its way to steamrolling Temple. Now it's up to the Owls defense to complement the offense for that long drive. 2nd and 8. Adams pursued. That's a good play in the open field to bring him down. Dana Levine, the sophomore out of Hallandale, Florida, who's really known as more of a speed rusher for Jeff Collins' defense. Makes it 3rd and long here.
Levine is fast because Josh Adams looked like he was going to get the corner, and that was an excellent tackle. He bounced it out there. You're used to seeing him break contain. Levine ran him down, held on to make a tough tackle.
Irish put three receivers to the right, empty the backfield with two options for Wimbush to the left. And we get movement on Notre Dame.
False start. Offense, number 72, 5-yard penalty, third down.
That's Robert Hainsey. He's the freshman tackle. He was the number one guard in the country in the high school recruiting rankings. Moved out to tackle. He's battling over there with Tommy Kramer. Really, nobody won the spot, so they're both seeing action here as we go through this first half.
And here in an obvious third down passing situation, he is the better pass block.
First penalty on the Irish this season. Third and 11. Temple brings five. Wimbush underneath. The crosser is Cameron Smith, but he's got nowhere to go. It's a terrific three and out from this Owl defense. Artrell Foster, the tackle. And Temple puts a drive together, gets a three and out, and they'll get the ball back before halftime.
There's pressure. They're bringing a blitz. Man-to-man coverage. Foster does a great job of staying with his man and securing the tackle to get off the field defensively. One missed tackle in man-to-man coverage turns into a big play.
Brian Kelly, conversation with the freshman tackle. Newsom to kick for the Irish. Good deep kick. From the 30, it's Mike Jones who's spilled right away. That is the third special teams tackle for Julian Love. There's new emphasis on special teams this year for the Irish. And Julian Love has put an exclamation point up there. Three special teams tackles in the first half of game one. What a week ahead. Thursday night, Super Bowl champion Patriots raise the banner, then take on the Chiefs. And Sunday night football, the Giants and the Cowboys. It all begins Thursday, 7:30 Eastern, only on NBC. Join Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, Michelle Tafoya in Foxborough, then Arlington. Four nights, three great primetime games. Pats, Chiefs open the season Thursday night. Georgia, Notre Dame here Saturday night. Sunday night, Giants, Cowboys. Great week.
Does it get any better?
No, it doesn't. It is going to be a whole bunch of fun. David Hood's the running back. Temple with a score and a stop on the last drive. And they've done it by going to the ground, but now Notre Dame is very aware of that with a tackle. It's Myron Tagovailoa-Amosa with the tackle. The freshman seeing some reserves come in on this defensive front.
Better you than me. Left side of the line. Just pushes, penetrates, comes through, cleans up. Jay Hayes was the guy actually who stopped the play, made a cut back in. That's good penetration, just solid penetration across the board from the defense.
That's why I love you.
You gave
full credit to Jay Hayes for the penetration because you didn't want to go Tagovailoa-Amosa. Is Marchi on second and 15. The fullback Sharga out of the backfield with his limited game. Savon Cooney, the junior from Palm Beach Gardens, Florida, with a stop. And the Irish defense now has Temple in third and long.
The boy's mother named him Myron. I'm calling him
that,
Myron.
That is very nice. They're going to need some depth up front, as the folks who follow all the offseason conversation for Notre Dame know very well. Depth on the front seven is an issue, so will they have the depth to go through the season and continue to make plays? Julian Okwara is one of those rushers off the edge of the bottom of your screen, 42. Third and 11. He's coming in because the screen is set up. Isaiah Wright's going to make a first down and more right into Notre Dame territory. 43-yard line. So a little bubble to the receiver, gains 30 yards.
Great play call in a situation where you're getting a zone blitz pressure. You're getting pressure coming from the outside. They're coming. Get it out of your hand. Get blocks downfield by receivers and linemen pulling out. You know it's a zone blitz, so you know you're getting pressure. You have more blockers than they do defender on the perimeter.
The left tackle was injured the last drive. Leon Johnson back in. Catherine told us just a shoulder bruise. They checked him. He's back in. And he got blown up on that play as the Irish had good penetration. Miles Morgan tackles David Hood for no gain. We'll start watching the clock here. Buck 45 to go until the half. Temple has all three timeouts.
Very important drive. If they could milk the clock, score at the end of the half, and make it 28-17 and be back in this ballgame.
And remember, they get the ball first to start the second half. Notre Dame won the toss, took the ball, scored touchdowns up four of the first five drives to start the season. Marching hot pass incomplete for Donis Jennings. It was a little bit high, but he couldn't haul it in. It's third and 10.
Another third down situation. Since it's third and long, you usually see zone coverages or a zone blitz where you're trying to pressure, but you're still playing safe behind it. That's what happened last time in third and long, where Temple hit the wide receiver screen.
It got very quiet here. Now the fans are re-engaged. Logan Marchi's got third and 10. He's got a good arm. That pass is incomplete. He slung it in there for Keith Kirkwood, who couldn't hang on to that hot shot. The Owls will have to punt it away with a buck 18 to go till halftime.
Boy, there was a tight window. Notre Dame backs out of a blitz look into zone coverage, and he tries to stick it in a tight window. Had a chance. Little out in front, reaching with the hands, expecting a hit.
Sure-handed Chris Fink was a walk-on, received a scholarship last year. He awaits the punt from Alex Starzik. And Fair catches it at the 10. 33 yards, and it was all net. It's like a fluted jump shot. Irish ball with a buck 11 to go. Coming up, State Farm Halftime Report, Liam McHugh. Down on the field with Chris Sims. Great to have them with us on the road here in South Bend all year. They'll have scores and highlights. We'll get to ask Chris about what happened with Texas today in their debut. High-scoring game with Maryland. The breakdown of the first half here, and we'll get you ready for tomorrow's Monster Energy Cup Series race from Darlington. A little throwback action coming for you tomorrow night, NASCAR. State Farm Halftime Report is ahead. Wimbush takes off, eludes the sack. What a run by Wimbush, as he's hit hard across the 25-yard line. That's a first down for the Irish at a gain of 16.
Just a safe call coming out of your own end. A quarterback draw turned into a big play because of a broken tackle. Watch Wimbush pull through it. Looks like Finch had a shot at him, and he pulled through that tackle.
Hurry up offense. Durham Smythe gets it towards the sideline. He's out of bounds. That stops the clock with 49 seconds left. And another gain for Notre Dame, this one of 8 yards.
But now you're in an area of field. If you make another play, you're staying aggressive here and going after a score beforehand.
Irish stay hurry up, even though the clock is stopped. Oh, he almost threw an interception. He threw it right into the hands of DeAndre Kelly. Just the big man, as he was up in the air, couldn't secure it. Dangerous throw by Wimbush.
He gets pressure up the middle, turns to throw, last second to throw the wide receiver screen. Right into the arms. Potential for Booth Lloyd to intercept.
If you could hit the pause button of life for 1/2 second, DeAndre Kelly could see that ball coming to him. Oh, he would have had a dream for an lineman. Third and one here now. Notre Dame will try to run and get it, and they will. Adams has got a lot of room. Couldn't get his balance, but shy of midfield with 3 timeouts in 40 seconds. The Irish can have a chance to add to this 18-point lead. Rushing half for Adams. Wimbush middle of the field for the tight end. Smythe holds on. Took the big hit. Down at the 22. Timeout Notre Dame with 30 seconds remaining. Yeah, they did take a timeout. That's a little bit of confusion there on the bench. As Brian Kelly then ran down to the sideline, thought they had the timeout. Now they do, and will step out for just a moment. Back here in South Bend, they're looking at Durham Smythe, who took that shot across the middle. He's certainly going to have to check him out. At minimum, you get the wind knocked out of you, but on top of that, I mean, he was exposed in the rib area when he caught that ball. Meantime, down to 23 seconds when the timeout was granted.
He did have time to pull the ball down and protect a little bit, but took the shot and held on. Usually those middle read balls are a little more up the middle of the field. He got forced a little bit across. The throw led him across to the backside safety, and Randall delivered the blow. He's gathering himself.
Delvon Randall, big hitter. with one there. So Smythe out to be looked at. Alize Mack is in. Wimbush throws and Mack can't hang on. Look out, one of the student managers on the sideline took the hit. She's back up and okay. And hung on to the Gatorade as well. That was good hands and taking the hit. This Notre Dame crew top to bottom has come ready. A little toughness for 2017.
That's where the offseason program came in handy for it.
All right, second and 10 here. Two timeouts, 21 seconds. They are in field goal range. From here, a field goal is 45 yards. So you want to manage the opportunity to get points. Slant is caught by Cameron Smith, but Temple folks want to say no catch. No definitive single from the umpire who's in there. And now a timeout is taken after Artrell Foster's hit. 10 seconds remaining. Third down coming up. Timeout. We'll take one more look at this. Cameron Smith, the graduate student receiver. He was at Arizona State the earlier portion of his career. Got contact by multiple Temple Owls there. And then you see the ball out of his control. That should be incomplete. It will be third and 10 with 12 seconds left. If the replay booth agrees with what we see in replay here.
And this is an area of the field with the time situation at the end of the half here where you don't want to get overly aggressive, just get some yardage for setting up a field goal if this gets backed up rather than be overly aggressive and go down the field. And I'm also curious to look at a clock synced up with when that ball was incomplete.
After further review, the ruling on the field is an incomplete pass. It will be third down and 10 with 12 seconds remaining.
So instead of 10 seconds, which is what it said on the clock when we went to break, it goes back to 12 seconds. You see the coaches during the year. You see Brian Kelly out there. When there's a timeout, you can come out to the numbers with your team. And there's a dead ball and a timeout. In other situations, you cannot do that. They're going to be very, very strict about coach demeanor on the sideline. You come out, it's a flag, it's 15 yards. We'll see how much that gets called in week one. The officials have told all the coaching staffs about it. They know what the deal is. Yeah, Brian Kelly wants his timeout back. He's telling his quarterback he got to snap it on the whistle. Because if Brian gets his timeout back, well, it's an incomplete pass, so it shouldn't have to be a snap on the whistle situation. Yeah, they get two timeouts back. He shouldn't have to snap it on the whistle because it's an incomplete pass and a dead clock.
With only 12 seconds, they could take a shot at the end zone here because they are already in field goal range.
Jose Mack is moving. Four-man rush. Wimbush puts it up top, and it's incomplete. Try to get Mack and the safety coming over. Randall again was all over that. Delvon Randall put the hard hit on a second Notre Dame tight end on this drive.
Pressure on the play coming off the right edge. But Wimbush hangs in there and tries to deliver it down the field. And Mack takes a shot. That's when you're throwing it up for your big tight ends, hoping they go up and make a play for you.
It's going to be a 44-yard field goal attempt for Justin Yoon. His career long is 52. His long last year was 40. That one off the upright to the right and no good as this half comes to an end. So a dynamic start for the Irish, but a strong finish to the half for Temple. Looked like Notre Dame was on their way to adding more points. But off the right upright from 44 for Yoon. And the half ends 28-10. So Jeff Collins' team got a little bit of momentum at the end of the half to take into the locker room. Temple gets it to start the third quarter. At the break, 28-10. Don't forget the halftime performance of the Notre Dame bands on NBCSports.com and the State Farm Halftime Report next after these messages from your local station.
You're watching Notre Dame football on NBC, presented by Bose.
28-10, the biggest numbers. Notre Dame on top as we look at our first half stats. Brought to you by Bose. You'll see a Notre Dame offense that had the offense, the numbers going and the numbers churning in that first half, Doug. Over 300 yards of total offense, 340. However, Temple got themselves back in the game, running the ball quite well at the end of this first half.
It was the running game that got it going for Temple, and Armstead's done a great job. But the offensive line's handled it up front. He also has a fullback in front of him leading the way. And Armstead is an explosive back. He's jump cutting, finding creases, gaining yards on the ground.
Temple gets the ball to start the third quarter. The kickoff return by Mike Jones, who takes it across the 25 to the 27-yard line. That's where Temple will start this third quarter. Notre Dame was terrific out of the gate. Temple worked their way back in the game. Important time of the game here as this second half begins.
No doubt about it. Temple got the ball in the end zone and then made a big stop at the end of the half to just hold to a field goal and keep themselves in the ball game. It looked for a while Notre Dame was in total control. Right. Definite momentum swing in the second quarter.
We're going to see him in a little bit. What did you think of Brandon Wimbush in the first half?
Outstanding. Very good. Used his legs. Took too many hits. Made some plays in the passing game and also using his legs.
For Temple, it's been Logan Marchie at quarterback throughout. Gives to Raquel Armstead for the first carry. And he is stopped for no gain. Let's see what the Temple side was thinking at halftime. Catherine?
Well, Mike, I spoke to Temple's head coach Jeff Collins at halftime, and he said on defense, the adjustments we have to do is we just have to run to the ball. He felt that in the first quarter, they're playing a lot of first-year starters, and he saw their hesitancy. He thought by the second quarter, they were settled in a little bit more. He said on offense, we really have to start controlling the clock. He liked the way they did it in the first half, but he said we have to do more of that and get these guys to settle down, Mike.
Okay, Catherine, thank you. It's a great play there by Tranquil. Took away the screen pass that Marchie was going to throw, and Dalen Hayes slings them out of bounds at around the 20-yard line. Boy, you talk about a team and defensive play. A lot of guys made good plays on that one.
No doubt about it. Hayes is putting the pressure on, so he figured out just dump it to the swing. And Tranquil was blitzing, but pulled out into coverage, continued the pursuit. Both Hayes's non-related.
Yes.
Making the play.
And Tranquil part of that as well. That will be credited as a sack for Dalen Hayes. That's two sacks for Notre Dame in the first half, in the first three quarters, I should say, of game one of the season. So now third and 16. And the redshirt sophomore from Bristol, Connecticut, and St. Paul Catholic High School just going to run it. Pitch, option, Armstead. Got some of it back, but nowhere near that first down mark. Nick Coleman on the tackle. Armstead thought he did not have a knee down, and he was able to pivot with his hand and stay on his feet. They're marking him back at the 31.
If his knee did not touch, at least his forearm was definitely on the ground. He's down, but running the option game a little of everything in the running game. There's the right forearm all the way down.
You can put a hand down, but once you get past the wrist bone on the way up the arm, that counts as a body part down. So Notre Dame's defense does what it needs to do. Three and out, and Chris Fink awaits the kick from Alex Starzik. Tumbling towards the sideline, not the deepest kick, just 34 yards, and Temple downs it at the 36. That's where the Irish will take over. A lot of talent on this Notre Dame team, including, Doug, the left side of their offensive line.
Yeah, Mike McGlinchey at left tackle, Quentin Nelson at left guard. Just been working hand in hand. Here's a double team where they drive their defender into the backfield. They're working well together. They've set up the running game where Josh Adams went for 130 yards in the first half. And even the quick pass set, no pressure from their side, dominating the line of scrimmage.
McGlinchey is a Philadelphia kid. The left tackle, Wimbush's pass is caught on the out. Freddie Canteen, who played his first couple of years at Michigan, oft injured, has come over to South Bend and makes the catch there. It's a guy we know and see often around here. Harry Heastand, the offensive line coach, holdover. The staff changes, no reason to change. One of the best in the business. Josh Adams to carry for a yard.
This relationship with that offensive line, it's a love-hate. It would sound from a distance. We heard him at practice the other day, and it just, he'll defend his boys to the hilt, but boy, he likes him up during practice.
Third and two at the 44-yard line. Notre Dame will use the tight end as a fullback, try to do what Temple was doing in the first half, turn and give, and Adams will get that first down. And it was Brock Wright, the freshman from Cypress, Texas, which is 28 miles northwest of Houston. He's seeing his first action here, and he makes the play. Everything with Brock's family okay, as we know. And let's just add our voice to the many on the air calling college football games this weekend, thinking of all of the good people of Southeast Texas devastated by the floods all the way up that southeastern coast. It's a difficult time in the college football community, and the football community as well, pitching in to do their part. Wimbush throwing complete, and it's Nick Wisher who caught a touchdown earlier across midfield. If you want to help victims of Hurricane Harvey, you can donate online, redcross.org, or text Harvey to 90999 to give $10. So many of you have. So many continue to do it to support the relief of the hurricane. Wimbush hit as he throws, and that pass complete for the first down to Chase Claypool. He's the sophomore from British Columbia who is really a talent that continues to emerge. 16-yard gain there.
Nice throw and catch here, but I'll tell you what, Wimbush has been hit twice in a row and he's getting up off the ground slower and slower.
That's a dangerous play. That pass is incomplete, intended for Cameron Smith. Temple was all over that receiver screen, including Mike Jones. Out of Baltimore, he transferred in, played his college ball at North Carolina Central until coming over here. And his first year with his Temple defense, and he'll be a factor for this team as the season goes on.
He's dynamic as a kick returner, great athlete back there in the secondary again. Coach said that all four of his secondary guys could have started down in Florida.
Notre Dame freshman Michael Young, 87 on the field in offense for the first time. Wimbush rolling. He'll keep it on second down into the sideline and gain 3 yards. Isaiah Graham Mobley, redshirt freshman on the stop.
Wimbush is getting his wish. He's getting hit a little bit. I was saying it about three or four plays ago, or coming out of the half, and in the last three plays he's gotten hit. There he stayed up on his feet.
Too many hits?
A little bit too many. He's going to have to protect. It's a long season. Run with it when it counts.
Pressure's picked up. Wimbush's pass is incomplete. Freddie Canteen couldn't hang on to that throw. From here, a field goal's 48 yards. With a slight helping wind at the back of Justin Yoon. And they will try the field goal attempt, it looks like. Here comes the place kicker, Yoon. Hit a 52-yarder against Navy 2 years ago. Hit the upright at the end of the half from 44 yards. This officially will be 47-yard field goal attempt. Montgomery Van Gorder puts it down, trying to hook it in and doesn't. Missed it to the right, no good. So Temple will take over with decent field position as the Irish have seen Yoon, who missed 4 field goals all of last year, missed 2 here today. Notre Dame football is brought to you by Coors Light. The key to a good offense is a refreshing defense. By GEICO, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. By Bose, get closer. And by AT&T. A different look here in South Bend, as we mentioned, the reconfiguration of the stadium. The Notre Dame band is no longer on the field. They're in the stands. Temple's band is here. They're up in the stands as well. So that sideline looks a little bit cleaner, less people on the sideline here. It started out as a beautiful sunny day, some clouds. The temperature's in the 70s for this opener. Logan Marchie sets up the screen. Quell Armstead made one man miss. Niles Morgan comes to tackle him after a good first down gain of about 7 yards.
Armstead is elusive. He's catching the ball out of the backfield. He only had 7 catches last year. I'm very impressed with just his ball carrying skills, making people miss in space, and actually the job the offensive line has been doing.
13 carries for those 70 yards for the junior from New Jersey. A Second and a couple on this one. Marching pass almost intercepted by Dalen Hayes, who was dropping in coverage, closing off that passing lane. Almost had an interception from his defensive end spot.
Great job. This is a zone blitz, so he's pulling out of here to get out underneath. And he gets right under it, gets a hand on the ball, and almost comes up with the interception off the tip. The blitz was coming from the opposite side, and he would drop out on the weak side underneath the route.
6'3", almost 260. We've seen him try to leap offensive linemen in this first half. Terrific athlete, a great playmaker. Started his high school days in California, finished at Skyline High School in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Third and two. Option. Tranquil made a terrific play and stopped Temple. And it'll be fourth down. Drew Tranquil, the captain's had a strong game here this afternoon, Doug.
Absolutely. He makes it look like he's going to take the pitch back and option coming off the edge. And he's feathers it, gets wide, and then breaks in and makes a tackle on the quarterback after the quarterback made the decision to keep the ball. So he stayed kind of in no man's land, broke back in, took away the pitch, and made the tackle on the quarterback. He's had an active game.
He really has. Playing that new spot for this Notre Dame defense, the rover position. Remember, hybrid, a little bit of linebacker, a little bit of safety. Fourth and three. Irish keep the defense out there in case there's a fake. It's just a rugby punt from Alex Starzik. The fake will stay away from. And that is why Starzik was very effective with these rugby punts. You really get no returns. It's so hard to get your hands on. 43 on the kick. Notre Dame leads by 18. Great close to the PGA Tour season playoffs rolling on. The final 70 will advance in the FedEx Cup finale. The Dell Technologies Championship continues. Dan Hicks and our NBC golf team will have that for you tomorrow on Golf Channel, then here on NBC. John Rahm's in the lead. Mickelson went low. Phil shot 67 today. You see Brian Kelly there. He brought up Jordan Spieth's tenacity and poise that he showed at the Open when we were over in Scotland in July as an example to his team of keeping poise under pressure. And their team has done that in the first half today. Good run by Adams here across the 40 and out to the 43-yard line. A little energized run by Adams, who's over 150 yards now, Doug. Just slow to get up.
Racking up the yards. He gets to the outside with a stiff arm, which we've seen before out of him. Big, strong back with speed. And he just puts the arm out, a little stiff arm, kick out of the tackle and take off.
Take a little pitch here and take a hit. And just try to go down before he loses too many yards. Temple had that one well read. Delvon Randall, the safety, has been active with the tackle. And now he needs to come out. He took a hit on that last play. But then no huddle was trying to stay out there. Tony Jones Jr. comes in for Josh Adams. The athletic training staff get a look at him right away. Loss of four on first down, second and 14. And here is Jones. He's one of the better pass catchers out of the backfield. Did a good job to avoid Artrell Foster tackle for loss and gain just about the yards that Adams lost on first down. And we have an injured Temple player down at the 41-yard line.
No gain.
Sam Franklin, the linebacker, injured. No check on him. Behind that guy is telling you to put the money down, or that it is a money down coming up, is the injured linebacker Sam Franklin. It seemed that Sam was being treated for what would look like cramp condition. Josh Adams in a similar boat as they look at him on the Notre Dame sideline. Third and 14 here for Brandon Wimbush. Looking left and throwing that way. It was right and intercepted by Mike Jones. Jones is a terrific kick returner. Turns this one into a return inside the 20. Jones down the sideline. Bumped out of bounds at the 11. And a game-changing play with Mike Jones on the first turnover of the day.
Brandon Wimbush thought Jones was getting run off in coverage. He had his head around, sees the ball thrown, settles his feet, and breaks back on the ball. He's throwing the corner route. Jones was playing deep third of the field. Saw the ball thrown, was able to put his foot in the ground and break to it. The corner route looks like it's going to be open, but he ignores the upfield route, has help from his safety there, and breaks on the ball. And then he turns into the kick return. Wimbush gets a lick in on at the end.
Jones could have gone to the NFL draft, got a fourth or fifth round grade. They thought he could get back, and he gets on that whiteboard that they put up there. When you get the board, he's the first to get the ball. He's the first one to be put up there today. They marked him out of bounds at the 14, and Notre Dame's defense with Tavon Coney, a quick response on Raquel Armstead, and no game. So Wimbush throws an interception, first time he's turned it over here this year. And Temple's got a great opportunity to make this a game late in the third and the fourth quarter. Wimbush on the phone with his offensive coordinator. Or rather, the quarterback coach, I should say, Tom Reese, who's upstairs with the offensive coordinator, Chip Long, being down on the sideline. Second and 11. The defensive tackle jumped, and the offensive lineman moved to force the flag on the defense.
Offsides, defense, number 95, 5-yard penalty, second down.
Tagovailoa-Amosa, Myron with the penalty, and Doug, that's now taught by offensive line coaches to react to that, to draw the penalty on the defense.
Once they flinch on the defensive side, if you move to in response to it, the penalty will be on the defense. In the old days, that wasn't the case. They could move around, flinch all they wanted. Now the offense is taught to respond to it. That's a big 5 yards. Puts him in a good down and distance and tight.
Second and 6. Fullback moving, trying to lead the way. Armstead cannot get there. Devin Studstill buzzing from the safety spot to tackle Armstead.
Sharga again with a great block on a lead play. But because of the penalty, Temple is in a situation where it's decent down and distance. You can still run pass, and not have to get in just to the throwing mode. Although third and medium here, expect pressure, some form of man-to-man coverage with an opportunity to make a play here offensively if you can hold up front.
See if Logan Marchi, quarterback with very little college experience, can make a big play down here. He's got pressure in his face, and Coney takes him down. Tavon Coney brings the heat. Third sack of the day for the Irish, and they push Temple back into field goal, a longer field goal range.
Great job of being disciplined by Coney and staying with contain. He stays, he's got contain. And my screen won't clear, but.
There you go.
He comes up the field. It's a naked bootleg action where you're planning on deception and get out on the corner, and he wouldn't have any of it.
And again, the pressure from Mike Elko, the defensive coordinator, coming from different places. This will be a 36-yard field goal attempt for Austin Jones. And he missed it left. So you talk about a defense making game-changing plays, something the Irish were missing last year. A chip shot turns into a longer field goal. 36 yards they miss. Coney's sack helps keep Temple off the board. Two brothers in the crime that shocked America, from executive producer Dick Wolf. Edie Falco stars in Law & Order True Crime, The Menendez Murders. Premieres September 26th on NBC. Back in South Bend, Notre Dame's defense comes up with a big play. And Mike Elko's team, 3 sacks for the defensive coordinator. This is a team that took 447 snaps last year to get 3 sacks. They have 3 sacks on 47 snaps today. There's been a bit of a difference in this defensive effort. Josh Adams back in the game. Catherine Tappan told us during commercial that he was being treated for cramps. He comes back with a good first down run.
Well, this is an interesting series because Wimbush had his first negative experience last drive. Let's see how he responds to it. And it would appear that Notre Dame is going to go to the running attack.
Yeah, Sheree Finch tackles Adams. Minimal gain there. Brian Kelly told us yesterday when we were asking about the qualities he's seen in Wimbush, the ability to park a mistake and not carry it over to the next series.
And that is so huge at the quarterback position, and especially when you're young. When you're young, it's kind of easier because you don't have so many negative experiences. They don't build up too quickly. But he is, he's so mature. He puts things behind him, moves forward.
Third and two. Let's see if they go behind that All-American left side of the offensive line. Be a play pass. Wimbush on the edge will throw it complete for the first down to Nick Wisher, the tight end, who's had a good presence here. Just 6 receptions in his Notre Dame career coming into today. 3 in this opener.
What a great find by Wimbush. His reads to the outside, outside, outside. He sees his tight end at the last instant. And it's a, that's a tricky little throw, throwing back to your left, finding him in a delicate spot. Great conversion.
Wimbush 14 of 24. Passing numbers. Tony Jones Jr. in the game, runs right. Ball comes out as he goes down. No whistle, and it's Rule Temple ball on the field. Thought he might have been down. Jacob Martin comes up with the recovery. Let's see, are they now going to say he's down?
The ruling on the field is a fumble, recovered by the defense. First down.
Let's see if it's out. That left knee looked to be down. The question was the ball coming out. The call on the field was fumble. Is it coming loose there? That is very close. They may have to keep that one on the field. Sharif Finch, their outstanding defensive end, with the strip. And again, do you have that indisputable visual evidence? The ball is starting to be pried out as the knee comes down.
The left knee was down first or the right?
I think the left knee.
So this may be down.
Okay, so there's the left knee down, and you see that
he's
still has it, but Finch is ripping at it.
So is it still under control, or is it out? That's a great job by Finch, just ripping at the ball. Terrific job.
And this is such a bang-bang play. He's still got a pin to him. I think he might be able to say that's indisputable video evidence. But again, the call on the field is fumble.
Exactly.
You got to be 100 guys in a bar. I have to tell you that
they
is.
They all agree, huh?
Right. And if you were in a bar in South Philly.
Even the, exactly, exactly. In Philly, all the Temple guys are going. You got to get 100 of them to agree.
Well, Tony Jones Jr. didn't play last year as a high school All-American, a guy who they were looking to be a good pass-catching part of this backfield dynamic. He's showing some strength. The ball's still attached to him as that left knee came down, then the right knee comes out, but it's starting to move out there. So, like, that last freeze frame there, that ball is starting to move out.
Well, the stripping action of the ball started before the knee hits. And then as the knee hits, you and I would say he's still got control of it, but is that coming out? And it has to be indisputable.
I see enough.
So now what do we think they'll say?
I've bailed on that business. I've enjoyed the last 9 months of my life when I had to try to figure out.
Don't even try. Yeah. I'm going to go with they're going to leave it a fumble. Even though I believe the knee was down and the ball wasn't quite out yet, but the stripping action had started, so it may not be indisputable.
And again, it's tough for the officials to call these. When you watch them real time, you decide real time what happens here. So you can clearly see why an official would have thrown the beanbag down and said it was a fumble recovered by the other starting defensive end, Jacob Martin.
And as an official, you want to err in the favor of the fumble because it can get overturned the other way. Mm-hmm. What if it's scooped and scored? It's a big play that you blew dead.
This Notre Dame offense, they came out with a very good first half. 340 yards has been a bit quieter here since scoring touchdowns on 4 of their first 5 drives.
It appeared that they were getting the running game going again, though, right here.
After further review, the runner's left knee was down prior to the ball coming out. It will be 2nd down and 3. The ball will be placed at the 38-yard line. Please reset the game clock to 2 minutes, 58 seconds.
Such a fine line. We both thought the knee was down, but I really didn't think they'd overturn. It was so close that I didn't think they'd overturn that.
Could have seen them justifying going either way there, even though the gut feeling was, yeah, stay with that call on the field. So Tony Jones puts it on the ground. He goes to the bench, and Dexter Williams, the junior from Winter Garden, Florida, comes in. It goes down as a gain of 6. And the 20-year-old Wimbush will give it to Williams. He'll get the first down as he's spun across the 45. He's going to get all that yardage, too, because he fell on a defender's body. So first down for the Irish. Chapel Russell made the tackle for Temple.
That left side of the offensive line is moving people. There's no penetration. They're walling their men off in the run game.
Back to Williams. Good gain as he moved up the middle. Dexter to the 47-yard line. Let's go back to that play you just talked about, Doug.
Just, I mean, this is a short yardage situation. Look at this left side come down. That's Quentin Nelson, 56. I mean, look at the hole. Look at the size of the hole.
You couldn't get through that. You get through that one. There goes Williams. Inside the 20. Pushed out of bounds inside the 10. So Dexter Williams gets an opportunity after Jones fumbled, and 3 runs add to his total, 40 yards on that carry.
Again, it's Nelson and Mustafa this time, left guard and center working together. Run the ball to the left side, coach. Let's keep running left until they stop at left. That's me as a player talking to my coach.
No doubt. 55 yards of running. Give it to Tony Jones, who takes it into the end zone for the touchdown. And again, that left side paved the way for a Notre Dame touchdown.
Quentin Nelson pulling out, securing the edge. Actually, initially, it looks like he wants to kick the defender out, but he hooks him. And watch him pull. I got the arm on the back there, coach.
That's a hold.
Was there a flag on the ground?
No, there was not.
Okay, there's not a hold.
He grabbed him and held on to him. So Jones comes back after the fumble. 3 runs by Williams. He comes down. And Jones takes it in. The extra point added by Yoon. And it's 35-10 Notre Dame. Here with a minute 22 left in the third quarter. Brian Kelly got here to Notre Dame. A couple of foundation 8-5 seasons. Then the big one, the 12-win season to the national title game. Lost to Alabama. Then 9-4. Dropped to 8-5. Remember, they were a great team at one point in 2015, just a few plays away from an undefeated season in the loss against Stanford. But last year, the drop to 4-8. And Brian Kelly had to change. He had changed the way things were done around here. He was very honest about it. He said it didn't live up to the bar that is set for the standard in Notre Dame. So he had to make changes. New offensive coordinator, new defensive coordinator, new special teams coordinator, new weight program. It's essentially hitting the big reset button, which coaches at big-time programs don't often do, especially at this point in their career.
I'll tell you, a big part of that when we talked to the players was Matt Bayless' strength and conditioning that created a mindset throughout the offseason. And you can see the difference in the attitude of the players and coaches around the locker room and when we had the opportunity to speak to them.
It's just interesting to watch. Brian's been so involved in the calling of the offense, and it's the move to a CEO head coach, like you see so many other coaches at this level in college football involved with everything. Gonna take this kickoff from 5 yards deep. Jones hesitated once, hesitated twice, and will take it out to the 30-yard line where he's tackled. Catherine Tappan, you've been on this Notre Dame sideline for several years now. Have you observed a different Brian Kelly at all today?
Absolutely, Mike. It certainly has been a different Brian Kelly. And I asked him at halftime what the difference is with his coaching style this year compared to previous years. He said he's been involved where he's needed this game, on special teams, offense, and defense. But he said, I'm really just trying to help my football team win this game. He wasn't happy with the last bad series on defense going into halftime. So he said there were a lot of things they had to clean up. But I've noticed him getting more involved as well with things happening off the field. They honored Bob Crable for the College Football Hall of Fame earlier in the game, and he stood and he applauded him and he shook his hand. We didn't see that in previous years, Mike.
Certainly not. Marchie from the 30. Temple's got to go to the air now. He finds Keith Kirkwood, gain of 16. And Catherine, what you were just talking about is a perfect illustration right after that kickoff. Brian Polian, who's the special teams coordinator, came right over to Brian Kelly, and Brian was having that conversation where at other times he might have been with the offense just going over what happened the last series. Frees you up to do different stuff.
oversee the entire game.
Napoleon, who was here last year as the head coach at Nevada, now has come back to a place that's very special to him, where he was an assistant coach, to control the special teams. Stephen Hood that carry, Jonathan Bonner with the tackle. Final half minute of this third quarter. Brian's so excited to be back. Of course, his dad, the Hall of Fame NFL executive, Bill Polian. Bill and his wife are watching Brian. So glad to have them back here in the Midwest, and you know, disappointed about the way things went in Reno, but happy he could come back to a place where it's a very good connection for the Polians. Slant caught by Kirkwood. Good looking receiver here. Inside the 35. He'll end the quarter at the 32-yard line, trying to keep Temple in this one as we head to quarter number four. Only touchdown to that quarter scored by the Irish. Off we go to the fourth in South Bend. It's Notre Dame 35, Temple 10. We'll return to Notre Dame Stadium after these messages from your local NBC station. You're watching Notre Dame football on NBC, presented by Bose. Our score by quarters is brought to you by Bose. Notre Dame jumping out to the quick 21-3 lead, had it to 28-3. Temple had a chance. It was 28-10 at the half. They had the ball inside the Irish 15-yard line. But a sack, a missed field goal. Notre Dame turned around and scored late in that third quarter on the run by Jones. And they lead by 25 to start the fourth. Logan Marchi's pass is too high for Keith Kirkwood. It's incomplete. And we'll have second down. If you're just joining us, this is a Temple team that won 10 games each of the last 2 years. Their head coach, Matt Rhule, has gone to Baylor, where he will get his season started against Liberty. That's a very difficult job to take over there in Waco. So enter Jeff Collins, the 46-year-old head coach, who's defensive coordinator in the SEC for the last 6 years. He was very good friends with Matt Rhule, took this job, has a Temple team that is young in some spots, especially quarterback, where they've been so solid for the last few years with Philip Walker. If they can stabilize that, they're going to be a factor again in the American Athletic Conference this season.
Philip Walker was a big graduation for them. He was a four-year starter, 47 consecutive games. But he was a playmaker and carried that offense. And you know, you're starting fresh with a young quarterback, and there are other things in place. I mean, we've seen them run the football behind a strong fullback and running game. It's a bright future, Temple.
Walker was with the Indianapolis Colts as cut down day, likely to be released, but we'll see if he can find a way to hang on and make the roster down the line. Third and four, quick to Kirkwood, couldn't get his hands on it. And Marchi's a quarterback who in high school threw for 112 touchdowns, threw for 9,000 yards. This was seen as his job to lose coming in, trying to find his footing here in this opener. And on fourth down, down 25. On fourth and four, they will go for it.
You know, that's one of those, it's got to be 100% completion. You sling it out there to your wide receiver with a cushion, and everybody's just playing a little fast. Creates the fourth down situation. A lot of man coverage in this situation. A lot of pressure been coming from Notre Dame.
See, one safety with the Irish have man coverage elsewhere. Timeout taken by Temple from their sideline. Was it before the flag? It was.
The only thing left for the Notre Dame defense is to create a turnover. Mike Elko's background, creating turnovers down at Wake Forest. They've gotten their sacks, but have yet to come up with a turnover.
So Jeff Collins, 46 years old, first time as a head coach, won a game, first time as a head coach, the place where Rockne coached, Notre Dame Stadium. But it's not his first time here. When the College Football Hall of Fame was in South Bend, he came and ran in a marathon 14 years ago. And there's his time, 3:49:38. The marathon started at the Hall of Fame downtown here in South Bend and ended at the 50-yard line. So the first time he was in that stadium was a marathon, and he begins what he hopes is a marathon of a coaching career as a head coach in that same spot. Pretty cool.
That is pretty amazing. That's wild. And to have your first coaching, your first job as a head coach, your first game at South Bend, it's pretty cool.
It is pretty neat. And I like his energy.
Nothing better for him would be to pull off the upset.
With Jim McElwain, the Florida coach, the last couple of years. And Jim taught him, I got to be myself. Be yourself as a head coach. Fourth and four, Dalen Hayes offside. So it's going to be an automatic first down for Temple as that pass was incomplete. Intended for Isaiah Wright.
There was movement by the right guard.
Offsides, defense, number nine, 5-yard penalty, first down.
I really thought the right guard moved.
Let's see. Hayes, see what you saw?
Oh, he taps the center and gets set. No, it was just him getting set. That's offside, definitely. It's on Notre Dame.
Look, you only had 14 sacks as a team last year. You have three in week one, so you're a little hungry to get some more. But it keeps Temple on the field, keeps him in the game here. Armstead to the left, going nowhere. Andrew Trombetti was the first one to get over there and start the play for the Irish. There's the senior from New Jersey.
He's had ample playing time since his freshman year. Never a true starter and a focus point, but always a guy that played a role in this defensive front.
Figured, Doug, he's going to be really like a third defensive end if everybody stays healthy, with Dalen Hayes and Jay Hayes at each end. Julian Okwara in rush situations, pass rush situations. Run by Armstead, who's getting close to 70 yards here on this opening Saturday of the season. And again, it's third down for the Owls.
You got to believe it's four down territory for the Owls, so you don't have to go after it. You expect some zone coverage. Don't force it up the field.
Third and 11, Irish plays zone. Pass in the middle of it is caught, and good second effort by Broderick Yancey. And the spot's going to be just inside the 10. That's a Temple first down. Gain of a dozen for the junior from Bradenton, Florida, who caught only four passes last year.
Boy, nice timing on just getting rid of the ball out of the shotgun. These quick passes are not easy out of the gun. To gather yourself, hit a quick slant in traffic. Look at that, when the ball was actually touched. Yancey comes up with it in traffic, breaks the tackle, gets the first down.
Seeing enough out of Marchie, the Temple quarterback, to feel good about where they can be as a season progresses through the next couple of games before their big one in week four against South Florida. End zone shot, busted coverage, drop ball. Kenny Yeboah is never going to have an easier look for a touchdown. Big play guy, a redshirt freshman they're expecting a lot of. It was right there for him.
Yeboah has the opportunity. It looks like it's going to be a wide receiver screen. Everyone jumps the wide receiver. Boom, wide open in the end zone. Off his hand. Yeboah, he's kicking himself. Here's his opportunity.
I think he was a good high school wide receiver, too. That, he grew into the tight end position at 6'5". Second and goal. Yancey on the edge. Got a block. Did he stay in bounds? Yes, he did. Touchdown, Temple. Broderick Yancey. And it's 16.
Great block by Kirkwood on the perimeter. And actually, Julian Love loses contain. Kirkwood made the block, and Julian Love got caught inside out to the corner. Looks like he stayed in, Coach.
Absolutely. Nice job for Yancey. And Broderick Yancey, two career touchdown receptions, both at home. A great place to get your first road touchdown as a collegiate player here at Notre Dame. So the score is 35-16. The margin is 19 at the moment. And Temple's going to go for two. Play clock running down. They're a little out of sorts here. And it's a jump pass by Marchie for Yeboah. Incomplete, and it will remain a 19-point margin. Yancey, the touchdown grab. He had a couple on that drive. Temple getting a little more comfortable on the offensive end. Still in a big hole. Notre Dame football is brought to you by the Lincoln Motor Company. By State Farm, here to help life go right. By Verizon, not just unlimited, Verizon Unlimited. and by U.S. Bank. In the Student Administration Building under the Golden Dome. Those 400 trumpets get you set on a football weekend, one of the many traditions. It's great to hear the band, to see the students.
There's nothing like the atmosphere of college football.
And again, here we talk about the Campus Crossroads Project, the $400 million over 3 years. It's been a construction site, really has been. But all these buildings that you see around the stadium that have been built, all the classes, student, academic needs will be taken care of in these buildings, as well as the surroundings for football Saturdays. Really well done. What about Wimbush today?
He's had a great day, but, you know, he did say he wanted to get hit and was looking forward to it. Well, he got hit today. He's on his back quite a bit. A couple of them he got spun around on. He's getting hit as he delivers the ball. That's, you know, some of the throws, though, he did stand in there, absorb the hit, and complete the pass, though. So good toughness. He was getting up off the ground a little slower as the game went, or has gone.
Tony Jones Jr. is back at tailback. He scored on the end of the last drive. Wimbush with time, shut downfield. Equinemius, St. Brown can't pull it in. Going for the home run shot to close out their workday. Just goes incomplete.
Boy, this is one where, look, we're going to go play action. I'm going to hold on to the ball. You just keep running. He runs past off a corner blitz, up through the safety. And your full speed, that's a tough catch. I mean, he is completely full stride reaching for that ball.
Second and 10, Wimbush will keep it here. Get to the edge, good move to get around and get the first down and get out of bounds, not take another hit. That's a gain of 13. Wimbush is near 80 yards rushing on the day.
Little agility shown there, a little bounce in his step, getting to the outside. And he's still running with the football. We're into the fourth quarter. He's taken a number of hits today.
To Cameron Smith on the edge. Smith will gain about 4 or 5 yards. See that Michigan-Florida game is a 9-point Wolverine lead in the third quarter. Of course, Malik Zaire was here at Notre Dame. He has gone to Florida. Only 4 of 6 passing for 35 yards and 1 rush for minus 2 yards. So Malik has not had a significant impact on a Florida team that has struggled in that game on the offensive end. Over the middle for Smith, the tight end extends. Did he keep it between his legs? No, it hit the ground incomplete. As Smith is slow to get up, as he sold out for that reception.
He caught a ball down the middle of the field earlier, took a big shot. He went after this full board, laid out. There is no fear in his, you know, the ball's over the middle, it's mine. He's going after it. And there's no hesitation as far as being laid out or going after the football.
He took that second shot from Sean Chandler, the safety coming across there as he was fully stretched out for the ball. To look at him on the sideline. Alize Mack comes in at tight end. Play clock running down. Brian Kelly able to get a timeout before the delay of game.
Alize Mack's had a rough day. He's dropped the ball. He had a shot at one that would have been in traffic with a big hit, but he just seems to be a little out of sync, standing around a little bit, missed a couple of blocks.
Third and a half dozen for the Irish when we come back. This has become fun. Labor Day weekend tradition returns tomorrow. Throwback NASCAR Monster Energy Cup Series racing from historic Darlington Raceway. Throwback paint schemes, a lot of fun stuff. Take you back to the 80s. Tomorrow, 6 Eastern on NBCSN. Kevin Harvick won the pole in qualifying today. He already has a win, qualified for the playoffs. We move towards that part of the NASCAR season. Third and 6. For the Irish, Wimbush pass is complete. Held on to by Equinemius St. Brown. There's a clear number one receiver on this team, and it is the junior from Anaheim, California.
He's had a couple big plays down the field, a 33-yarder, a 34-yarder. He's the go-to guy.
4 catches on the day. Tony Jones Jr. carries for just a few. Mike Jones has been very active for Temple. With the tackle.
Here's your guy that's a kick returner. He's a corner. He's coming up and making plays. Had the interception. He's all over the field.
the flinch on the right side of that offensive line. Not been too many mistakes
here. Ball start, offense, number 72, 5-yard penalty, second down.
Robert Hainsey, the right tackle. It's the fourth penalty on Notre Dame, 5 for Temple. It's been a relatively clean opener. Well, Hainsey's going to come out, and Tommy Kramer, 78, is going to go in.
A couple plays ago, he got beat on the completion to St. Brown. He got beat in pass protection. So the right tackle position in general is still going to be a work in progress.
It's one-on-one time with the coach. Wimbush on the design run. That's his patented move. That spin move, he is great at that. But a yard and a half shy of the first down as Sean Chandler tackles him. Gain of 7.
Boy. Quinton Nelson and Mustafer in the middle stay on a double team, but here's the spin, and he ends up cutting back behind Nelson, back out to the right. I mean, that's just vision, athletic. He's relaxed now. He's just playing and being athletic, relaxed.
And Bush throwing it over the head of Alize Mack. You may remember as Alize Jones last year, getting his name legally changed, taking the name of his stepfather. So Alize Mack, player missed last year with academic issues, and had a lot of time with Brian Kelly. We do weekly meetings with Brian Kelly. Really a big part of this Notre Dame team. If he is, and he's done everything right, as the coaches have said through the offseason, if he can continue on, his performance could be difference making. A flag was thrown, but there was no penalty on the play as the officials converse, so it will be fourth down.
It was one of those plays behind the line of scrimmage where his buddy, his other tight end, Nick Wisher, threw a block for him and laid a guy out, but it was behind the line of scrimmage, so he was leaving.
Offense will stay out there on fourth and 2 at the 41-yard line. They bring Brock Wright, the tight end, in as a fullback, and he will lead the way for Jones, who is stopped. So Temple has played a pretty good second half here. A chance to gain a lot of confidence coming out of this second half. Dana Levine, the sophomore, made the tackle. And the Owls will take over at the 41. Just over 9.5 left in the season opener in South Bend. Notre Dame led 28-3 about 4 minutes into the second quarter. It's 35-16 now. Just past 5 minutes into the fourth quarter. Irish season opener. Georgia comes into South Bend next Saturday night in primetime here on NBC. A rare SEC team visiting South Bend. Be a great atmosphere next Saturday in the stadium. Marchie, deep shot downfield. That's Mike Jones. That is the corner coming over to play. No, it's Marshall Ellick, the other number 10. Beg your pardon. Marshall Ellick hadn't played yet today, and he comes in. Ellick, the junior from Richmond, Virginia, who played 5 games as a starter last year, had not seen the field as a receiver. He's one of the players who was listed above the line, Doug.
Of what line?
The Jeff Collins line.
The Jeff Collins line.
Jeff Collins line.
Not like the Mason Dixon, the Jeff Collins.
We'll explain in a second. Second and 10, and Armstead is stopped behind the line of scrimmage by Niles Morgan. So Jeff Collins doesn't put out a 2 deep. You know, is it the Jim Harbaugh play of we're going to play, you know, a sophomore game of we're not going to tell you? Not really. But his deal is if you play well enough that you'll see the field, I'm going to say you're above the line. So on Monday, instead of a 2 deep, who's going to be the fullback, who's the backup, all that stuff, he just put out a list of players who are above the line, who are likely to see play today. The other guys are working hard to get from below to above the line. This is caught, but shy of the first down for Adonis Jennings. It'll set up fourth at about a yard.
One of the other aspects of that was he didn't want a guy to feel like he's a backup. He sort of lists them as a 1A and B, and you're going to play, expect to play. Don't take that mentality of being in a backup role and you're just a backup.
It was off his earlier experience in his coaching days. He had a second string safety who had to come in and play, and he just thought he was a backup. So he was loafing through practice, wasn't as much attention to detail, and he said, that's it. I'm never going to have guys as backups anymore. You're going to be above or below the line. trying to get to that yellow line at the 49 for the first down, and Notre Dame stops him. Greer Martini caused the fumble that Tranquil picked up and takes to the 34-yard line.
Greer Martini, Hayes, Dalen Hayes coming from the backside. Watch your backside coming.
Hayes and Martini combine, along with Jonathan Bonner. Martini's hit knocked it free.
Right on the ball for Martini.
And then Hayes punches it out.
He may have punched it out just before getting to the ground. May want to take a look at that.
Well, for the moment, it was fourth down. It's Notre Dame ball either way. It was marked as a fumble, an Irish ball at the 34. We'll see if they look at it again to respot the ball. In any case, it's Temple's first turnover of the day.
Fumble recovered by the defense. That play is under further review.
So they'll take a peek at this in replay to determine where the ball will go. But
either way,
it continues. Either way, it's Notre Dame ball. It continues a terrific day for Drew Tranquil in that Rover spot.
And there's potentially your first turnover of the day for Notre Dame defense.
Yep, that ball's out. His hand is on the ground, not above the wrist bone. So that would be a body part not down, a fumble.
Great job of coming down the line, just closing his athleticism from behind.
Hayes, you're talking about Dalen Hayes.
Dalen Hayes.
Well, Dalen Hayes has the ability to be the difference-making playmaker on that front seven for the Irish, and he has shown it today in a variety of ways. And this is a player who's a sophomore, came in last year, played a little bit during his high school days. He didn't stay healthy. He couldn't stay healthy. So he bounced around a couple different high schools, was out in California, then moved to Michigan, as I mentioned before. He played high school football at the same high school where my kids play sports. So I got to see Dalen play, and he was a big deal to get there at school ranked, but he couldn't stay on the field and healthy.
The field is confirmed. First down.
And now he comes here, Notre Dame. He gets to learn the defense. And this year, it's a different level. That plus the new strength and conditioning program get you a player who a lot of people recognize as a five-star talent who could be a difference maker going forward for the Irish.
We've seen him leap guys in pass rush, drop out and get under in coverage and almost intercept the pass and then chase plays down from behind and cause a fumble.
So at the 34, Wimbush remains the quarterback with Josh Adams in it, running back, and Wimbush will be sacked. That's Quincy Roach, number 90, redshirt freshman. The speed rusher gets in there for the sack for the Owls.
Absolutely, coming around the right edge, and this is the weak spot for Notre Dame. They have tight ends on that side of the formation. No one bounces out. Probably Alex Barr's responsibility to bounce out there and maybe pick up the outside rusher. Great speed rush, as you said, coming on the edge.
For Roche, from Randallstown, Maryland, and now Wimbush will keep. Nice run by Wimbush. See that first down marker, gets there, stays in bounds inside the 20-yard line before Delvon Randall tackles him. There are two flags, though, back where the quarterback departed. It's a 22-yard gain if it stands.
Personal foul, hands to the face, defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
And the run will get Wimbush to near 85 yards now, rushing on the day. There's the hands to the face on the inside. Bade had the hand up in the face of the center. So that'll be tacked on to the flag, to the game, I should say.
Quinn Nelson strong, though, huh? Arching the back, holding his ground, not giving up.
Right, it was Nelson, the left guard, not the center. First in goal for the Irish. Wimbush pressured, escapes, trying to make something happen, stays on the run, and that's a lot for nothing. No gain.
He's getting a little carried away, trying to make plays, running around. It's just he's becoming very instinctive in this game now. Levine had the pressure coming up through the middle here. Watch the left side come right through. It was initially a wide receiver screen, but the pressure was so quick it just didn't happen.
It's one of those moments, 35-16. Why do you have a guy in there at this point? Do you want to get Ian Book the backup sometime? Well, it's only 68 snaps. This is twice the snaps he has in his entire career. So you have that, run that fine line of experience, close the game out on a positive note. Wimbush to Alize Mack. He'll be down just inside the two with Sean Chandler on the tackle.
And Wimbush is picking himself up off the ground again, as you said. But there's a mental discipline that comes with finishing the game and running all the plays. Georgia next week should be a very physical game. Do you want your quarterback taking these hits?
Confusion, Irish trying to get lined up and running to get the timeout is Kelly. Second timeout taken.
Second charge timeout. Notre Dame.
30-second timeout. So it'll be third and goal with 6 minutes left. Doug, you mentioned it's Georgia next week for the Irish. Then they go on the road for a couple of games. Seven home games this year. No Shamrock Series game this year. Irish will go to Boston College and Michigan State for back-to-back games. Then back here to take out Miami of Ohio. In October, it's at North Carolina. North Carolina with a surprising result today. And USC, which is in an early dogfight with Western Michigan, all even at 14, a couple minutes till halftime in that one. People are pointing to NC State to maybe be a surprise team. They'll come here to South Bend, Wake Forest as well. Then at Miami, an annual game against Navy, and then the West Coast trip to see Stanford around Thanksgiving time, the Irish schedule for 2017.
We spent some time down at Athens, took a look at the Bulldogs, and they were flying around. Kirby Smart, very vocal in practice. Nick Chubb looks like the old Nick Chubb, healthy. The Irish will have their hands full.
Kirby Smart, the second-year coach, taking over with Mark Richt, who's the coach now at Miami. Strong performance on the ground for the Irish. See if they punch this one in on third and goal. It is Adams to the right. And Adams is denied. When you talk to Temple, they tell you that Delvon Randall, who made that play, and Sean Chandler, who we've seen also today, are as good a pair of safeties as you'll find in the country. And that's a statement, obviously, you're going to make if you think your guys are good. We've seen that they can play with anyone out here. They are very good players. Don't know if they're the best tandem in the country, but they're eye-opening. Good stuff.
Physical close on receivers, close on running back. Fourth down, they should be running the ball left.
Irish going to try it to the right. Adams powers his way into the end zone for a Notre Dame touchdown. Second of the day for Adams.
Well, Notre Dame's tight end slash fullback, right at fullback, came in as a tight end catching balls, but also backs up into the backfield acting as a fullback. So we've seen some power football tonight from both sides.
We saw 84 on the field as well, Cole Kmet. Kmet 84 and Brock Wright 89, two of the top tight end recruits in the country. No school had a pair of tight ends come in at their level as Yoon adds the extra point. Both on the field there, both figure to be a part of this season as they go along. Use of that tight end position and the running backs. Adams, 161 yards and two touchdowns today. Brian Kelly just finished a conversation with his quarterback, Brandon Wimbush. And Ian Book, the backup quarterback over there, speaking with them as well. A good day for the Notre Dame offense, which has racked up 42 points and 537 total yards. See, Kelly had a conversation with his quarterback on the sideline. The quarterback's smiling and laughing. You know it's been a good day.
It's been a while since we've seen that.
Good day for Notre Dame for sure. Isaiah Wright with the kickoff return just across the 20-yard line. Next week, two legendary programs will collide right here in South Bend.
The last time Georgia and Notre Dame played each other was over 30-something years ago. For Notre Dame to be playing an SEC team at home is something that's really unusual.
You ain't seen nothing like this.
Georgia want to prove, no, the dog's still alive.
Bring in the Georgia Bulldogs and let's go. You ain't seen nothing like this.
Dogs Dogs and the Irish. It'll be cool. Just great traditions. Those two men, Herschel Walker and Tim Brown, the last two Heisman winners in each school, have both known championships, including Georgia when they played Notre Dame in that famous Sugar Bowl with Herschel Walker in there. So that'll be next Saturday night here on NBC. Logan Marchi to the air and Marshall Ellick across the 40-yard line with a good catch and run for the first down and a gain of 19 for Ellick, who caught 12 balls last year. Troy Pride Jr. and some of the reserves get into the secondary for the Irish with a stop there. Temple opens up in the Philly battle against Villanova at Lincoln Financial Field next week. Right back to Ellick again. Dante Vaughn, the sophomore from Memphis, on the tackle.
Marchi has a great feel for timing, especially the intermediate, the short routes. The ball is turned loose on target. They have the ability to make plays with this offense, and their tall, lanky wide receivers are big playmakers.
The time Isaiah Wright, the catch, a good block by his offensive lineman downfield, springs right to the 38-yard line. You mentioned the Villanova game at the Link next Saturday, then a Friday night game against UMass, a couple of home games, then a very big Thursday night game at South Florida. South Florida's the team picked in the east of the American Athletic Conference. Then Houston on September 30th and on through the remainder of their conference schedule. Marchi shot downfield. Kirkwood incomplete. You see Houston on that schedule, and Major Applewhite taking over as the head coach at Houston. The priority is, of course, everyone living in that southeast Texas area and is having a chance to have food and water and their health and picking up the pieces. And in the football vein, Rice and Houston will be two programs that I think a lot of people around the country will be pulling for as they try to put the season back in place at some point when it's reasonable for them, both displaced because of the just horrific conditions post Hurricane Harvey. But Houston in the same conference as the Owls. This is David Hood, and a good read from the secondary position when Tavon Coney came up to make that play. Dropped as a linebacker, came up to make the stop. Limits the gain, it'll be third down.
If Coney doesn't make that play and shed a block, that's a big play. Temple's answer to all the blitzing and zone blitzing has been wide receiver screens and screens to the tailback.
Third and 10, right back out to Hood. Coney again in the open field with a good tackle at the 31-yard line. 3-yard shot of first down.
And now just a steady dose of zone coverage. Back off, keep it in front of you, make them put a bunch of plays together. Temple moving the ball methodically.
Fourth and 3, trying to keep this drive alive. It's incomplete as it was intended for Isaiah Wright. So 3:22 left, 42-16, and we'll see if the Irish get Ian Book.
Exactly.
And the number twos out there on the offense.
And Ian Book's a guy that every time I have seen him throw the ball has been impressive. Throws the ball on rhythm, throws on time.
Nope, it'll be Wimbush again. Book remains with the red hat on there.
Nope.
So the starter will stay in for the Irish.
Obviously, Brian Kelly wants to finish strong. He wants to see his guy take this from beginning to end, make a statement game in his first game. He did take a bunch of hits today, and we were kind of questioning whether or not he should still be in there. He is young, and he can use the experience.
Yeah, we were talking about that during the break after the last Irish score, keeping Wimbush in. This is Dexter Williams, full speed, 30, 20, Williams down at the 2-yard line. Delvon Randall, who's seen a bunch of snaps out there, didn't quit. 67 on the game, and the Irish have run for over 400 yards here today.
Cole Kmet, 84, freshman tight end, gets a great block up in the middle and springs him loose. Dexter Williams takes it for over 400 as a team rusher.
Williams just short of the goal line as he tries to get the payoff touchdown there. 2:42 remaining.
I knew Notre Dame would try to run the ball a little bit more than usual than what we have seen.
Well, they have 3 100 plus yard rushers in this game, and there's 2 of them. Wimbush gives it, Williams scores it, and the Irish put up a 7th touchdown on the day. Well, Dexter Williams deserved that. He had that long run off.
Give it to him.
That guy's tired, and somebody else comes in and gets the sugar at the end. But Williams, who had 200 rushing yards last year, one of the big examples of the new strength and conditioning work done here by the new staff at Notre Dame. His body has changed significantly. Looked really good in the spring game. Matt Bayless has done a sensational job with a lot of the players on this roster. Williams, one of them. Yoon adds his seventh extra point. 49-16 for the Irish here today. Doug, it was an onslaught at the start for Notre Dame. A great beginning to the season and a lull there in the middle. Does it mean anything to finish this strong for Notre Dame and pull away in the fourth quarter?
I think it does. I think they needed to make a statement, say we're back, the 4-8 season's over with, moving forward. And to have that kind of momentum from beginning to end, a 60-minute game is important, because they had moments last year. Great quarters, but not the whole game put together. Second quarter, Temple game momentum. Mm-hmm. Started to make it a ball game and turned it around. The stop and a missed field goal stemmed the momentum and put it back at the defensive side of the ball. Pressure on the quarterback, creating a turnover, doing a lot of things on defense.
Well, let's come back to the theme that we started with earlier this afternoon. New field, new coordinators, offense, defense, special teams, but a new strength and conditioning coach. And the difference, everyone said, that the presence of Matt Bayless has made is significant in the offseason. And there he is. He was at the University of Connecticut the last 3 years. And his presence with Notre Dame has just changed the approach to what happens day in, day out in that weight room. Mike Jones on the return here to the 30-yard line.
What he did during the offseason was create a new mindset, a mental toughness. Kids getting up at 5:30 in the morning, talking about how when they finished the workouts on a Thursday, they called them mat drills, that getting through that drill was tougher than anything they had done the year before. And they would sit in the locker room looking at each other, proud of themselves just to finish and get through that. It created a mindset and a mental discipline that they could handle anything.
2:22 left before Temple's drive starts. Let's go down to Catherine.
Well, guys, just an update on Notre Dame tight end Durham Smythe. He went to the bench, as we saw earlier, to get examined by the medical staff. They removed his helmet and took him into the medical tent. He has now been on the sidelines. He was talking to Chip Long on the last defensive drive, but he is ruled out for the remainder of the game. Mike?
Okay, Catherine, we'll watch during the week to see if he returns to practice. Kareem making the stop there for the Irish. Here was the play as Smythe reached out, couldn't bring in that ball, and then coming over from the safety position, the contact made by Sean Chandler. You could see, and Smythe's defenseless at that point. Chandler's trying to pull up, but the shoulder pad still hits the helmet. And one of those things, the medical tent on the sidelines, Alabama brought this to college football and now the NFL as well. It allows the athletic training staff to go into more private place, concentrate, eliminate some of the exterior distractions, and diagnose any potential concussions for players or other injuries if medical staff so choose. Gardner is popped and hit. And this Notre Dame defense, Osmar Bilal, with that play, they are also bringing an attitude that, Doug, you talked about from that strength and conditioning program, translating it onto the football field.
I saw Drew Tranquil early in the game shed a tackle, throw the blocker off, and make the tackle. You could see the explosion in his leg, much stronger on the field and on his feet. And the speed of the defense is definitely improved.
Final minute here, so Jeff Collins will have to get his guys back in Philadelphia and back pointed towards the remainder of their season. A couple of games at home that they'll have a great chance to win and get set for a very big game in their conference season at South Florida, in their hopes of playing for the conference title for the third consecutive year. Meantime, Notre Dame's defense will feel very good about the first game under the Mike Elko era. 71 plays and 327 yards, but a turnover, three sacks. Team that took a long time to get those sacks. Okay, done. Nick Chubb, Sonny Michel.
Next.
Georgia Bulldogs. Yeah. 40 years old, really good coach. Two young assistants, relatively speaking. One from Wake Forest, Elko. Chip Long, the offensive coordinator, coming over from Memphis. We're stepping into a big pressure situation for them. Win one in the books.
How about Chip Long at over 400 yards rushing offensively? Just a complete day.
three 100-yard rushers. Adams with 161, Williams with 124. And in the debut for Brandon Wimbush as the Notre Dame quarterback, 106 yards and a rushing touchdown, and 184 yards passing and two touchdowns. 49-16 as Brian Kelly get win here in the opener. Notre Dame all time moves to 107-17-5 in their opening games. And it's celebrated for a few hours and then start thinking about the Georgia Bulldogs.
Well, Brandon Wimbush used his legs today, threw the ball effectively and moved. Did not stand in the pocket and have to throw a lot of out-of-pocket passes because the running game was so good.
This will be a great night for the Irish to celebrate and enjoy. Brandon Wimbush's mom and dad, or Brian Kelly there. His parents very happy to, they know the stress that he's gone through as well. Say Brandon Wimbush's mom also, she has feels so good for her son getting this great performance in his first game at Notre Dame. And something that didn't happen with a victory on the scoreboard for the Irish very often last year, the alma mater after a win. The relief those guys must be feeling, right? There is Brandon Wimbush's mom. Very happy to see her son play so well in his debut. Heather Wimbush, that phone's going to be blowing up now, Mrs. Wimbush. Your son did so well. Here's Catherine with Brian Kelly.
Coach, congratulations. A big victory for you in the first game of the season. What impressed you most about this win?
Well, you know, we had a quarterback that hadn't started before, and I thought just getting him in the flow of the game, he made some plays and got more comfortable and learned a lot today. So that's huge. I thought running the football today, you know, we had a lot of big plays running the football, exerted our will against a team that's won 10 games over the last 2 years. Really good opponent. And then I think defensively, we you know, we found a little bit more about ourselves in terms of what we can do. We've got to continue to progress there, but I think there's a lot of positive signs that we can take. And I think more than anything else, this team's got a lot of pride that's going to build during the year.
Coach, thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks.
Mike.
All right, Catherine, thank you. Brian Kelly's full press conference is coming up for you on NBCSports.com. Tonight at 8, 7 Central on NBC, it's America's Got Talent, followed by Dateline Saturday Night Mystery. Tomorrow, 6 Eastern, NBCSN, that Labor Day weekend tradition returns. Throwback NASCAR Monster Energy Cup Series at Darlington. Next Saturday night, see you in primetime for the Irish and the Dogs under the lights here in South Bend. With Catherine Tappan, Doug Flutie, Rob Hyland, Pierre Boussard, great team in the truck, Mike Tirico. So long from South Bend. Thank you for watching Notre Dame football on NBC, presented by Bose.